Hayes, Lauren, and RJ, The Frangie Show starts now on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Hey, welcome in. Glad you're along for the ride on this Monday installment of the program. Frank Frangie, Hayes Carlyon. Hang on.
How are we doing?
We're good. We're doing better now. So got the everything working. Had a little make a little adjustment here, but we're glad you're with us on this Monday installment of our program. We are live from Sawgrass Country Club, the East West. Gorgeous, and you see a bunch of golfers out here behind us. They're finishing off the Haight Invitational, which is one of the really cool college golf events in the country. They do a great job. John Haight, one of the great donors here to UNF, puts this thing on every year, and they do a fantastic job of it. What a gorgeous day. A little bit cool, but what a gorgeous day on the golf course today for all the folks playing out here. Some of the better teams, Lauren, in the country, UNF and JU are here. So is Alabama. So is North Carolina. What a wonderful event every year here at the Sawgrass Country Club.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks so much to UNF for having us out because it is, yeah, like you said, it is just a stunning golf course. And, Hayes, it really gets us in the mood for the Players that begins tomorrow.
It's hard to believe that the Players has arrived. And what a great way to kick off the week being out here. It is just absolutely an incredible facility and a lot of great players out here. I mean, we know firsthand what UNF has, the firepower. And, you know, it's going to be fun to see these guys come in and hear them tell us about how the course played today and how they feel like it went. And then, yeah, absolutely. We got a big golf tournament to preview coming up in the next 5 days. Should be a lot of fun.
Yeah, we really do. So we'll talk a lot about golf and what's going on out here, what's going on across the street at the Players down. It's an exciting time. This is one of the most exciting, fun times of the year in golf. We can't wait to talk about that. So there's all kinds of things to get to. That's about it. There's not football, is there?
Yeah, boy, it's been slow today. Not a whole lot going on in the world of the Jaguars.
What a good day. What a good couple days. What an exciting couple days for the Jaguars. I think, listen, if we still believe, and I do, that Josh Allen will get an extension, we know he's going to be on the football team. I would say the Gabe Davis news confirms that I was wrong about Ridley, and Ridley will play elsewhere when he makes it to free agency. But I think Gabe Davis is an awfully good player. So I think this is a good couple days for the Jaguars.
Today's been, I think, an outstanding day. I thought the offseason got off to a really rock start, but I think now, I mean, it's well on its way to being a fine off season because of the moves that they've made today. Landing Mitch Morse obviously solves their most glaring issue at center. I do like the add of Gabe Davis. I think that's a good pivot. We'll see. You know, national reporters are saying they're still trying to get it done with Ridley. It seems like the math is starting to really work against him, so we'll see. But I think Gabe Davis is a nice pivot. So, yeah, they've done a lot of good things. I like the Savage signing because, you know, Antonio Johnson with 150 defensive snaps, you know, maybe it was a little bit of a leap to just pencil him in to being Rayshon Jenkins' successor. Now you've got an established guy in Savage partnering with Cisco, if that's the way they choose to play it. With Antonio Johnson, I'm sure getting a chunk of those nickel snaps depending on the matchup. So, yeah, I really like what they've done today. I don't know how much room they still have to operate, but obviously, look, if they get a Josh Allen deal done, then that's going to significantly drop that number from $24 million probably somewhere to around 7 or 8, and then you've got the mobility to go make a couple more big moves.
Yeah, I liked the Darnell Savage signing as well because I did think that the secondary had too many questions to move forward and be confident. So I like that. Kicker Will Lutz, I like that too, since McManus last season certainly had some issues. Frank, what I find kind of funny is when the Mac Jones trade news broke yesterday morning, you would have thought that the Jaguars would never win another football game in for the rest of mankind, the way that everyone reacted on Twitter. But then as soon as Mitch Morse was signed, and then obviously these other moves like we just talked about, then everybody flipped completely.
I was astounded at the negative pushback on Mac Jones. I think Jaguar fans are just so upset. And I say the pushback, it's only on Twitter. That doesn't mean everybody,
right,
you know.
Right.
But I mean,
but that's where the majority fans' voices are heard.
But I thought, Lauren, okay, all right, Mac Jones, you got him from a six-round pick, so six-round picks don't impact the league, so you got him for nothing. I don't know if Mac's a very good player. I hope he is. You know, I'm rooting for him because he's a Jacksonville guy even before he got to the Jags. But you want to come – C.J. Beathard, God bless him, has started 13 games in his career Mac Jones has started 42. C.J. Beathard, Hayes has three career wins. Mac Jones has 18. Mac Jones has been to a Pro Bowl, albeit as an alternate.
And Jeremy Feller tweeted out, C.J. Bethard's been banged up. Yeah. I don't know if he would have been healthy before the season, but that certainly goes into it.
Mac Jones has been in the league 3 years. He's had three offensive coordinators, one of whom was the defensive coach, Matt Patricia. Again, I don't know if Mac – and he's coming here as a backup. Mm-hmm. I thought – and, hey, tell me if you just – I think if the San Francisco 49ers had sold, had done that deal with Mac Jones, went and got a first-rounder for a six-round pick to be a backup to Brock Purdy, I think people would have said shrewd. I think because the Jaguars did it, people said, oh, what are they doing? I don't know if Mac's a good player. I hope he – who knows? You know, look, I'm the one that said Kyle Trask would be as good as him, and neither one of them have had great careers. But I the pushback to Mac Jones – and, again, I don't think – who knows if it even impacted. By the way, if you play, you have to play your backup very long, you're not very good anyway, right? So that one surprised me, all the pushback to Mac Jones. I wasn't excited about Mac Jones. I wasn't bummed out about it. I thought, okay, like Bucky Brooks said, solid move to get a backup who's played way more than the other backup.
Yeah, I mean, I would say – when a player's going to get cut, I don't like giving up a pick to acquire them. So, I mean, that's – but, again, in the litany of things, like if this had broke 15 minutes ago,
correct,
no one
great
would care.
Great point. Great point.
It's just it's the way in which the news was delivered.
Well said. Well said.
I mean, I wouldn't expect Mac Jones to have much of an impact. And if he does, they're in trouble. I thought Mac Jones would be great. I thought he'd be the second-best quarterback in that class, which has just really turned out to be a disappointing one. I mean, it's basically Trevor – who's been okay, Justin Fields, who's been okay but is going to get traded, and then everybody else has been a disappointment. Can he salvage something here? You know, we'll see. I don't have a problem if he's replacing Beathard, but then cut Beathard, you know, so that you can save that money.
Yeah, one of them are going to be on the team, I would think.
So, from a cost standpoint, is assuming they – cut Beathard and save the $2 million that they would save there, then, yeah, I don't have any problem adding Mac Jones's salary. It's not inconsequential, but it's fairly meager. I think he was going to get cut anyway.
Yeah.
You gave up a pick for somebody that was going to be a free agent. Yeah. But yeah, it's fine. I mean, again, you got Mitch Morse. You got some receiver help. You got some secondary help. I'm not going to sit here and – get upset over a backup quarterback trade.
And by the way, I'm told somebody, Jonathan Jones, said the Jags had the only offer for him. That's not what I'm told. I'm told there were four or five teams trying to figure out – they didn't want to offer very much, but there are four or five teams that liked him as a potential backup. I don't think he's Justin Fields or Russ Wilson who's going to wind up starting somewhere, but I don't think the report implied that nobody else wanted him.
Correct.
That's not accurate. I can definitively tell you that's not accurate. And I think then Rappaport later said there were four teams in it. Well, that's way more accurate. I can tell you that. But either way, so look, I like what they've done today. I like the fact I'm not smart enough to know who's good and who's not. What I do know is, as I said it at the handoff, and I've been saying it on this air the whole time, they believe they're in their window. Whether they are or not, they believe this is the time to go try and be one of the better teams in the league. They believe up until the last 5 weeks of the season, they were one of the better teams in the league. And so why not go? I'm not surprised. Are you guys surprised? I am not surprised that there's a lot. I was asked this last week. I think I said there will be a lot of activity for the Jags in free agency because now is the time. We made the analogy from when they went and got Bryce Pop and Carnell Lake and Hardy Nickerson back in the 90s because that was the time. I equate this to that in their minds. I'm not saying they're as good. There's not a Baselli or a Fred Taylor or a Jimmy Smith. But I equate this to that time in terms of psychologically where I think they are.
Yeah, I mean, none of the guys that they have signed are like A-list free agent guys. But that's what we thought. They're probably not going to be able to sign, you know, one of these, quote, superstars of free agency.
Christian Wilkins probably wasn't
but
coming.
But they should be able to add like three or four really solid plan B kind of level free agents, and that's what they've done. And again, the biggest thing is, you know, you started to really get worried about the offensive line. I thought they should have moved on from Brandon Scherff. They end up restructuring him. You know, Cam Robinson, I thought was, you know, certainly you could justify releasing him. They wanted to keep Cam Robinson, so you had to do something at center. So that was the biggest check mark that Trent Baalke got today. He brings in a center that's played with Patrick Mahomes, Josh Allen's worked under Doug Peterson, has a very good idea of what's to be expected, and is used to playing playoff football. So That's a great move. And again, the receiver core, if it lost Ridley and was going to have to rely on a draft pick, that's a little bit of some uncertainty there. You bring in a pro in Gabe Davis, who, you know, obviously in Buffalo proved he couldn't handle being the two, but here, you know, you're talking about a guy that is going to be in there with Kirk and Ingram and Zay for now. And, you know, and so if he's one of four cogs, then I think he can be a very productive player.
Yeah, look, the Jaguars had to do something about the center position, and we worried that they wouldn't based off of different comments since the season ended. And so I think Morris was a huge signing for the Jaguars, and I think he's going to make the offensive line a lot better. And maybe it makes Luke Fortner better in the long run, but for the here and now, you might be able to run the football.
Right now, Luke Fortner, who they drafted relatively high, Walker Little, who they drafted higher, are two young guys they still have some hopes for. If everybody stays healthy, they now can develop. That's all of a sudden now your sixth and seventh offensive linemen. I think there's teams that wouldn't mind having those guys as your sixth and seventh offensive linemen. So, and again, they've just started. There's a lot more to do, but I like kind of where they are. So we got a lot to do. We are live at Sawgrass, Sawgrass Country Club, where the Hate Invitational is going on behind us. They're wrapping it up a little bit. Still some golfers on the golf course. Later on, Scott Schroeder, the golf coach here, will join us. Nick Morrow, the athletic director here, will join us. We'll talk golf on a beautiful, gorgeous afternoon here at Sawgrass. But let's start with some Jaguar football. Let's go one by one. Who the Jags have added? What deal did they made? How much better a football team are they now than they were a week ago today? That's our conversation piece. It's 1010 XL and 92.5 FM.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010 XL. Hit back with Hastings.
More touchdowns, birdies, home runs, and slam dunks. More heartbreakers.
Every time you lose, you die a little bit.
And more victories.
And it goes for the win!
1010XL.
At Hodges Mazda, we are proud of our solid reputation in the Jacksonville community. Lauren Brooks here. As your hometown Mazda dealer, our high customer service standards and our huge inventory of new and used cars provide our customers a consistently first-rate car buying experience. Our professional non-commissioned sales team puts your best interest first without exception. And every vehicle purchase from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com and discover the Hodges Mazda difference.
Get ready for the Players' Championship, March 12th through 17th at TPC Sawgrass. Don't miss your chance to watch the PGA Tour's best compete to etch their name in history while enjoying a vibrant social scene. From local bites to the latest merchandise available in the PGA Tour fan shop, the Players offers the ultimate experience for everyone to enjoy. Secure your spot today. Tickets are on sale now at theplayers.com.
Frank Frangie here for South State Bank. Look, I depend on South State for so many things, personal accounts, small business banking, and banking for our nonprofit. South State Bank can help you reach all your financial goals too, whether you're just starting out or focused on financial planning. South State offers convenience with their online and mobile banking. You should check out South State Bank as they were recently recognized by Forbes as one of America's best banks. That's South State Banking Forward, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Men, suffering from ED or PE? You'll see instant results on your first visit at Prime Men's Medical Center. For a limited time, your initial consultation and first treatment are totally free. You'll even get a gift that enhances performance in the bedroom. Call 904-664-8217.
Break free from the old school hassle at All Pro Roofing. They've revolutionized the game. And guess what? No more pressure, hassle, or time meeting with someone face-to-face for a roof quote. Unlock the power of an instant roof quote right from the comfort of your home. Get the information you need when you need it. Explore your roofing options today. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Hit that instant roof quote tab for a free instant roof quote. allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060138.
Add an ace to your Tuesday morning.
The third ace in 4 days.
Brunch with a Tour.
Tour news, tips, and inside info.
Brought to you by Clearwater Irrigation and Art of Natural Stone.
8:30 Tuesday morning on 1010XL.
Hey, sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. If you're still in the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is a one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with a real-life Vegas experience right from the comfort of your phone. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the MyBookie website. Sign up now and take advantage of a generous welcome bonus on your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200, get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun doesn't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide who to put your money on. The best part about MyBookie, you can bet on anything, anytime, from anywhere. Use promo code 1010XL to secure your welcome bonus today. Only with my book.
Hey gang, Hicken here. March is Workplace Eye Wellness Awareness Month. Here's a tip for those in front of a computer all day. Follow the 20-20-20 rule. Set a timer as a reminder to look 20 feet away every 20 minutes for 20 seconds. This can be as simple as looking away from your computer screen or out the window. If virtual meetings keep you in your seat for extended time, shut your eyes for 20 seconds. Call or visit BowtonEye.com today to schedule your consultation. Bow Nye, keeping the First Coast focused.
Tim McGraw. In concert. The Standing Room Only Tour 2024. A night filled with your favorite songs. Five-star Veterans Memorial, March 14th. With special guest Carly Pierce. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com. Don't miss Tim McGraw. Live in Jacksonville.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. Get ahead of the changing season with Fenwick Home Services by scheduling your AC system tune-up now. Their experts will perform a multi-point cleaning and inspection that will breathe new life into your system and help prevent breakdowns. Whether you need routine maintenance, repairs, or are ready for a system upgrade, Fenwick has you covered with 24/7 availability. Book your visit online at fenwickhomeservices.com/1010XL. FenwickHomeServices.com/1010XL.
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Dandy Foods. Dandy subs and sandwiches, look, we always want you to think about those great options as you're driving around Duval. But the beauty is, even as I'm dropping pounds, Dandy's got great options for me as well. Told you all about their protein packs, delicious salads that they have out there. They have fruit cups for on the go. You know what they have, veggie snack trays. You can grab those on the go as well. Perfect healthy snack. Dandy is the name to know when you're on the go. So stop into a Gate store anywhere around Duval and make yours a Dandy, and do it today.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
And we thank our friends from The Best Bet as always. Always a Best Bet Monday around here. They do a fantastic job, our friends at The Best Bet. So there's three great locations. I think you know that by now. There's St. Augustine just off of I-95. That's the newest one. That thing is gorgeous. There's the location in Orange Park. Been there for the longest time, right there on 17. And the beautiful crown jewel is the Jacksonville location on Monument Road. Big location, clean, and what a healthy atmosphere and a fun gambling atmosphere. So head over to the Best Bet. And always thanks to our friends at the Best Bet. Always a Best Bet Monday around here. The news of the day, you know by now, the Jags have changed their football team. Today, the news came out that Mitch Morse signed. That's the one that I really wanted. I of all the ones out there, I don't usually go on and on about a guy. I made this point last Thursday on our show, that he fit in so many ways. He's physical. He's a veteran. He's played with Patrick Mahomes and Josh Allen, so two very good quarterbacks. He's played on winning teams. And I love the fact that Gabe Davis is coming with him. So really, to take a closer look at those guys, by the way, our friend Ryan O'Halloran is going to check out. He works at the Buffalo newspaper now. He was at Denver and then here before that. He certainly knows both players very well. So we're going to pick O'Halloran's brain about both Mitch Morse and Gabe Davis. But those two players here. But Mitch Morse is the one I really wanted. He's now the center, a veteran center. Luke Fortner becomes the backup there, I would imagine, will be on the team. Walker Little becomes a backup now. So the offensive line now is a veteran line with a young right tackle. The offensive line now is Cam Robinson. He's a veteran. He was on that 2017 team that was so good here. Ezra Cleveland's the guy they really wanted, the veteran who formerly was on Minnesota's team. Obviously, Mitch Morse now a veteran center who's played in both Kansas City and Buffalo. Brandon Sheriff, a veteran right guard who's been around a lot. I'm with you, Hayes. I wasn't sure they were bringing him back, but they have, with a better deal now that saves you a lot of cap money, which is a good thing. And Anton Harrison, one of the better rookie linemen in the league a year ago. So now all of a sudden the line looks and feels a little bit different. They only changed one guy out, but if, again, as Doug Peterson said at the combine, the other four guys hadn't played together very much. And now they will. So Mitch Morse now on the line. Gabe Davis is the different kind of receiver. He is 6'2", 225. He's a big physical, high point guy. The Jags did not have that. The one type of receiver they didn't have is a big guy to go up and get balls, and now they have that. Even if Ridley's back, they weren't going to have that. They weren't going to have a go up and get the ball big physical receiver. Now they've got that in Gabe Davis, so I think that helps the cause. Darnell Savage, to your point, Lauren, a safety now, a veteran safety. I'm not completely convinced Antonio Johnson isn't the starter. I'm not, but we'll see what winds up happening there. Will Lutz, the kicker, will come in here and compete. Remember, Riley Patterson is here, Brandon McManus, so there's other kickers. The bottom line is they went and made their team better. I think they – you said it right, Hayes. It's not like they went out and signed Christian Wilkins for big, big, big dollars. But what they did is I think they were going to be aggressive. I'm not completely sure they're done. I think this is a different football team than the end of the season with, and I'm not surprised. I believe they're in their window, and I think there's a belief that this group will help this team be a better football team.
Yeah, and I mean, again, now you go into the draft, and, you know, I still think corner at 17 makes the most sense. But, you know, they've done a good job of patching things up here so that the needs aren't incredibly obvious, and there still could be some guys that they bring in of, you know, that are quality but at a lower cost, guys that could certainly help them. But, yeah, I mean, to get the upgraded center, that was absolute requirement for this to be a successful offseason. They've done that. I do think Savage is going to be a really good safety here. You know, and I think looking at Gabe Davis, and I think this environment – is also really good for him in Buffalo, and Ryan can speak more to this when he joins us, but it was sort of like, okay, we have Stephon Diggs, you go be the number two, and he just struggled in that role. I think here, we talked a little bit about this with Ridley. I think it's sort of the same thing with Gabe Davis, except you're not dealing with the rust. I think you just tell Gabe Davis, look, just blend in here. You don't have to be, you know, the star. You don't have to be our number two, you know, our definitive guy there. You know, with Christian Kirk, and again, for now, Zay Jones is on the team. Obviously, Evan Ingram caught a ton of passes last year. So, I mean, just kind of find your way here, and you'll be fine. But you got to love adding a guy who's caught 27 touchdowns in his first 4 years in the league. I mean, he basically catches six or seven every single season. He's been very consistent with that. And sure, he's not going to be catching passes from Josh Allen, but I think our guy is pretty good too.
Yeah, and Frank, I would imagine that Ridley is not on the Jaguars football team in 2024.
Yeah, I would think. I've said all along, I don't want to be a stubborn guy. I really believe they'd find a way to keep him. I can tell you, Lauren, my belief all along was, talking to them both publicly and privately, I knew how much they really wanted him on their team. I can tell you, without getting into detail, off-the-record details, I can tell you all the on-the-record stuff we all heard them say, they really liked Calvin and they really wanted him here. We're not making that up. That's a realistic deal. He's a guy they really liked and wanted him here. I also can tell you that Calvin told people close to him how badly he wanted to be here. Now maybe I'm naive and maybe that happens all the time. Maybe every guy that plays somewhere tells people I'm trying to stay, and the team says I'm trying to keep you. Maybe you know what I mean. I understand that.
Well,
part.
No, I mean, I think it's for real. He didn't want to learn another playbook.
Yeah, and I know for a fact he did it. So you add up all those things. I thought he was, but I don't want to be stubborn either. It doesn't seem to make sense that Gabe Davis would come, and now they're totally different kind of players. Calvin's a stretch the field guy. He's a stop and start guy. He's quick. He's smooth. Gabe is a big physical guy. So logic would tell you that. Here's what we do know. They're not going to have Gabe Davis, Christian Kirk, Zay Jones, and Calvin Ridley on the team. Right, Hayes? I mean, if somehow, miraculously, Calvin Ridley's here.
Then Zay's out.
Then Zay's probably out. So I think we probably don't think they're all going to be here. So to you, I'll give you a long answer to a short question. It now doesn't look like he is going to be, and I thought all along that he would. So I thought all along there was a chance that he would. So we'll continue to track that. By the way, the same thing about Mac Jones. I don't think it matters. I mean, I don't think it's awful that Gabe Davis is from here. He's from Fernandina. You know, this is a guy that's from around here. Mac's from around here. I don't know how much that matters in the long run, but it doesn't hurt, you know?
Yeah,
I mean, I don't know if you do it for that reason, but if that's an added benefit, why not?
Well, I mean, anytime at free agency or a trade, you know, you worry about acclimation, and it certainly helps if the player is familiar with the area, has family here. Yeah. So, yeah, I would think that that would be – again, it's – for Gabe Davis, I think it means a lot. Hopefully for Mac Jones, he's here for a year. We never really see him. And then he moves on in free agency somewhere else.
Yeah, I mean, that's right.
You know, I mean –
that's exactly right. He's here for a year. He still wants to start in the league, and hopefully he still gets a chance to start. I don't know if he's going to. But I think he gets a chance to start in the league. And so, so again, this is a guy that, as a backup quarterback, is a guy that's played a lot of football. As backup, I mean, he's been out of the league for 3 years. I mean, he's been in the league for 3 years, been out of college. He won a national championship in college. He has had three coordinators in 3 years. If your quarterback goes down for three games and you have a really good team, who's most likely to win those three games for you? Mac Jones or C.J. Beathard? Logic would say Mac Jones. No, we don't know.
Yeah.
Neither one of them played a lot.
I mean, with Mac, a lot of it's just going to be like, where's his confidence? I mean, you heard things coming out of Patriots camp with him that, you know, were really concerning, I would say.
It was a bad end.
You know, I'd say it's kind of a push between the two. But, look, I mean, again, I'm not going to sit here and pound the table and say, oh, my God, they should have – you know, gone and signed Drew Locke instead of made this trade. It's inconsequential. I don't like giving up a draft pick for a guy that was going to get cut, but, you know, they decided that they could afford to do it, so he's here, and like we talked about, hopefully he'll never have to play a meaningful snap for the Jaguars, and Trevor will start play every significant one, and, you know, they won't have any issues.
As for the other ones,
real quick, though, going back to Mac, you did hear some stuff to Hayes' point about maybe not necessarily the best culture fit. That's the first guy I feel like that the Jaguars have brought in a long time, where preceding him comes the I'm not so sure about the culture.
Yeah, and to that I'll say this. He played at Bowles for 4 years. He played at Alabama for 4 years. He could have left. He was behind Hurts, and he was behind Tua, and he was behind everybody, and he never left, and he was a holder on kicks for about 3 years, and he never complained, and he waited his turn, and he played under Nick Saban, and I never heard one whisper about culture at – and I don't know Mac at all. This isn't –
No, I was surprised, too.
I've never heard – and now the Patriots stuff didn't go well. There was the one – he was accused of being a dirty player on one play. He was accused of not being a team player a couple times. Now, I heard him, too. But this isn't – if we're trying to be fair, this isn't a guy with usually culture problems. There's years and years of there's all kind of examples, right? I never heard a negative word about Mac Jones, the person, ever until the last year or two in New England. This guy's 25 years old. The first 23 years, I didn't hear a word about that, right? So, and I don't know the guy. Let's be fair. Has there been a lot of stuff in his – I mean, Alabama, not a word. This is a guy that waited and waited and waited and waited his turn, right?
And I'm not worried about it here, really, he's not going to be asked to build the culture. I mean, it's Trevor's team.
That's right.
It's Trevor's room. Trevor's probably gotten to the point that, you know, I think you could always have the 34-year-old journeyman as sort of the big brother. But, you know, Trevor's not a rookie anymore, so he probably doesn't need that as much as he did it at one point. He's not going to learn anything from Mac Jones, I wouldn't think, but that's fine. I mean, hopefully Trevor can now teach Mac, and maybe there's some value in that, you know, Trevor kind of being the alpha in all ways in that room when it comes to experience and everything like that. I just think they should cut Beathard because, to me, it doesn't make sense to have the money devoted to your backup position.
I doubt they're going into the season with three guys. Yeah. I would guess one, and maybe.
But I mean, I'd cut Beathard today to have that money.
I hear you. My guess is they're going to both go to camp, and I don't know this. They may happen tomorrow, Hayes. I hear you, but it wouldn't surprise me if they both go to camp, and the guy who fits the culture, fits the team, fits the offense, fits Trevor, the best is the backup. That, again, if Mac Jones was going to get cut anyway, still might. You know, so you gave up a 6th-round pick. Again, with all due respect to Tom Brady, Antonio Brown, and Brock Purdy, 6th-round picks rarely affect a team. That's just, if we're being honest, there's rarely a major impact from a 6th-rounder. So that's the gamble you took. So we'll see what happens. But so that's my answer to you, Lauren. If this is a guy with a history of culture problems, a diva in high school, transferred to 8 schools in college, then I'd feel differently. And again, he had the someone called him a dirty player because of one play, and the play did look shaky. We all saw the play, and there were some culture things. But I'm like Hayes. I've talked a lot about Mac Jones because the pushback surprised me yesterday. But I think it's an inconsequential move compared to all these very important.
There's
moves.
No doubt. It'll be an intriguing storyline in OTAs.
And that's about it.
And then, by the time you get to September, you hope the name Mac Jones never comes up until you get to the end of the season and you look at a free agent list and you say, oh, Mac Jones, free agent.
Well, Frank, I think it's because of the timing of it. Again, this is before Mitch Morse was signed.
Correct.
So all Jaguars fans at that point in time are thinking they're running it back with the offensive line. Therefore, Trevor's going to get hurt. That's why they have to go after another backup quarterback.
Yeah, the running back team's out of business, isn't it? The team running back's out of business because obviously not running it back. Running back was the phrase we heard on every Jag Twitter everywhere for the longest time. Let's talk about the guys that aren't going to impact before we get to Ryan O'Halloran. A couple thoughts. Which one has the most significance to you, Morse?
Morse by a mile.
By a mile for me.
I mean, by a mile.
Because that was the weak area.
And he's going to play if he's healthy. I mean, that's a guy that's going to be on the field for over 1,000 snaps.
Yeah.
I mean, so, absolutely. And, I mean, again, that is a really core position. Other than quarterback, if a team loses their center, nothing affects a Vegas spread more than not having your center. So when you can upgrade at that position – and bring in somebody with his experience and the fact that he's worked with Mahomes, he's worked with Josh Allen, familiar with Doug Peterson, that couldn't line up any better.
Well, and I will and to that end, I usually don't get caught up in I hope it's this guy or that guy because there's so many free agents out there. On Thursday's show, I spent a whole segment saying this is the one guy I hope they get, and we point. And, I mean, I the whole segment, but it was the 3:30 segment on our Old Rock Thursday because we did two things. We talked about only the young good die young for about 5 minutes, and we talked about Mitch Morse for 5 minutes because he fits on all those fronts. So, and that was a clear weak area. I said many times my defending of Trevor and play calling and all this is because I thought they were so weak in the interior of the offensive front that they had no chance. And I said that all along. I'm not saying that's not a new opinion. I said that all along. I think Mitch Morse changes that significantly. So I think that one's first. I'm real intrigued with how the Gabe Davis acquisition changes them in the red zone. Big receivers help you in the red zone. I think he can stretch the field. That one I will tell you I never saw coming. And maybe some people said, I thought that. I heard them connected to him. I did not see that one coming. That one surprised me in a very positive way. But I'm not surprised they went and got a safety, Lauren, to your point, because they cut a safety. So I'm not shocked by that. Get as many kickers as you can in here and get the right one. I'm not surprised by that. Mitch Morse, I had a hunch. I'm not surprised by that. I never saw the Gabe Davis one coming.
Yeah, I mean, and again, I thought it would be Ridley or bust. Meaning they would either get Ridley back or they would invest the 17th
thought the same
or
thing.
48th pick in a receiver. If a receiver is there that they love, by all means, take them. Because you do need to invest through the draft at that position with some premium capital, not fifth, sixth round guys like Parker Washington. So, I mean, in looking at it, they could still do that. But now they don't have to do it. I think if they'd lost Ridley and you came into the season with Christian Kirk and Zay Jones as your two, absolutely you've got to add to that position in the first round or second round. Now with Gabe Davis, again, somebody that, between Ingram, Kirk, Zay, assuming he's here, and Davis, I mean, you've got four guys that can all score touchdowns in bunches. I really like the move. And again, I like what he's going to be asked to do here. I don't think he's going to be asked to, be the absolute number two option. In fact, most weeks I would say he's not going to be that. It's going to be get the ball to Christian, get the ball to Evan. Obviously, they'll have stuff for Zay, and they'll now have stuff for Gabe Davis. But I don't think it's going to be anything that's going to overwhelm him.
I think this is also an opportunity for Trevor Lawrence to show that he can make his receivers better. I mean, he's certainly been surrounded by some talent on the offensive side of the ball, the most obviously this past season. Well, now he's got a guy that's coming in who's, a 700-yard receiver last season. So this is a chance for Trevor to develop a relationship with him and to improve him.
We'll see what happens. Let's take a break. Our friend Ryan O'Halloran, who worked here, did such a good job covering the Jags for all those years, moved on to Denver and did a lot of work with the Broncos, now is in Buffalo covering the Bills as a columnist and reporter there. He certainly knows Mitch Morse and Gabe Davis very well. What does he think of those players? He also knows the Jags well, so he'll have a pretty good insight, I would imagine, into how this all works together. Ryan O'Halloran joins us after this. It's 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
The Florida Gators are on 1010XL.
The rivalry returns to the diamond. Florida State Baseball. Tomorrow night at 6 on 1010 AM.
Doc Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly, or we'll make it right. Doc Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Doc, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Hey, it's Hicken with 1010XL. The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is currently hiring for police, corrections, 911 dispatchers, and various civilian jobs. And for a limited time, JSO offering a hiring incentive up to $10,000 for police and corrections applicants. Details available at joinjso.com. Start your journey as a law enforcement professional, helping us drive down crime and foster positive relationships with citizens. If you're ready to be part of the solution, apply now. The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is an equal opportunity, equal access employer.
Frank Frangie here. Bono's Pit Barbecue is celebrating 75 years of serving up legendary barbecue in Jacksonville. And to celebrate, they've brought the old-fashioned basket back for a limited time, and it's better than ever. The classic open-faced barbecue pork sandwich served on Bono's signature bread, topped with crispy French fries, and your choice of sauce is just $7.50. It's sure to fill you up with flavor and memories. A limited-time offer starts on March 4th. So get your old-fashioned basket for $7.50 today, and if you don't see a pit, it ain't legit.
Start your Sunday off with a cup of Joe and some sports medicine intel. This is Joe C. inviting you to join me and Dr. George Barry for Breaking Bones every Sunday morning at 7:30. And if you miss an episode, just look for Breaking Bones wherever you listen to podcasts.
Big Chief Tire has been Jacksonville's trusted tire expert for over 60 years. Frank Frangie here. The new season is upon us, and they are here to ensure your journeys are smooth and worry-free. Gear up for any travel by scheduling service at one of their five locations. From tire rotations to custom wheels and more, the experts at Big Chief are here to ensure your vehicle is ready. Visit the website at BigChiefTire.com or call 904-932-0950 to schedule an appointment today.
Hacker here, and after my announcement of starting Awaken 180 weight loss, everyone is asking me about it, so I'll update you. After just 2 weeks, I'm already down 25 pounds. 25 pounds in 2 weeks. And to be more detailed, I actually dropped 32 pounds of fat, but I've gained 7 pounds of muscle. Not because I'm working out with Awaken 180, but because I'm more active, walking more, and playing longer with my son, Little Hack. All the rewards I thought would take months to achieve, I'm seeing after only 2 weeks. Am I starving myself? Definitely not. You think this guy would choose a calorie-counting diet? I'm eating to lose weight with Awaken 180, and my results speak for themselves. It's been simple. My coach lays out the plan, we make adjustments, and every week, the weight falls off. No pills, no injections, I'm doing it the right way. Do what Mike, Matt, and I did, and make the call to Awaken 180. 844-346-1800, or online at Awaken180WeightLoss.com.
Is your roof showing signs of wear and tear? Call Universal Roof and Contracting today to schedule your complimentary roof inspection. Right now, get $200 off your roof replacement plus flexible financing. And as a bonus, receive free window mitigation with a full roof replacement. This offer expires March 31st and restrictions apply. Universal Roof and Contracting, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Clear water.
John, I can't even mow my side yard. It's so soggy. Man, my builder sucks.
Brent, calm down. This is a common problem in neighborhoods where houses are built too close together. You need gutters and a properly installed French drain that will soak up subsurface water. We can completely dry it up.
So I can take my builder off my speed dial now, huh?
Yeah, we got you, buddy. Let that builder bitterness go.
Clearwater Irrigation.
And drainage, too.
Ackerman Cancer Center now offers total body MRI, the latest industry-leading technology. Just one non-invasive scan provides a complete picture of your health. to detect and monitor cancer with precision at AckermanCancerCenter.com.
Hey folks, it's Chevy truck season at Nimnick Chevrolet, and there's no better time to do what you do best than a Chevy Silverado. Now at Nimnick, you can save up to $10,000 off a new Silverado. Plus, well-qualified buyers can get rates as low as 0.9% financing on all new Silverado 1500 models. That's right, 0.9%. And with the largest inventory on the ground, outstanding cash incentives, and of course, that best price guarantee. Your perfect truck is waiting for you at Nimnick Chevrolet. And it all starts with a Chevy truck. Remember, Nimnick will give you top dollar for your trade as well. You can shop online 24/7 at NimnickChevy.com or visit the dealership, easy to find, right there at the corner of Park Street and Cassett Avenue. You want a great truck? You want a Silverado from Nimnick? That's Nimnick, your friends in the car business since 1941. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella windows and doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
Glad you're with us on the program. Frank Frangie, Hayes Carlisle, and Lauren Brooks with you on this beautiful Monday out here at the Haight Invitational. It's Sawgrass Country Club. We appreciate our friends from The Best Bet for sponsoring every Monday program. It's legal tampering day. You know that by now. Jacksonville has become Buffalo South. Okay, that's a reach. But there's a few bills coming here now. Our friend Ryan O'Halloran covers the bills in Buffalo, joins us now on the program. Ryan, how are you, man?
I'm good, Frank. Good to join you guys.
Good to have you on.
O'Halloran's in the package, right?
Yeah,
we get O'Halloran with Larson Davis, correct?
Absolutely. Well, they wanted Trevor if we get O'Halloran.
Ah, okay, that's so
that
a tough one.
It was a lot of talk about what to do, and so there you go. Ryan,
checks in the mail, Frank, for that one.
Hey, I'll get to Gabe Davis in a second. Ryan, I want to ask about both guys, but Mitch Morse is about the one about whom I'm very interested. I thought the Jags had a real area of need there. Physicality, veteran leadership. He looks like the right guy. He was the center for Patrick Mahomes before Josh Allen. Obviously, you know him well. You know his style of play well. Before we talk about how he fits here, tell me about Mitch Morse. What do you think of him?
I mean, this is my 21st year covering the league, and I put him in my top 10 guys. Okay. He was our good guy award winner up here in terms of meeting with the media. So very insightful, very calm. A very good presence in that regard. And let's face it, he's played with good guys, and he's earned the trust of a young Patrick Mahomes. He earned the trust of an in-his-prime Josh Allen. So I think it's a huge win for Trevor Lawrence, because he's going to be lining up behind a guy who has 126 starts and, more importantly, has 13 playoff starts, almost the whole season. So he's seen everything. He'll help him at the line of scrimmage, help him during the week, and also some of the younger guys on that line. He'll be a great influence. So when Mitch was surprisingly cut by the Bills last week, I thought the Jaguars made a ton of sense, and they came through and didn't let him leave the building, so to speak.
Ryan, what was the sense from Buffalo's fans? Were they upset to see him go, or was it sort of like, well, that's cost of doing business, and we'll just replace him?
Yeah, a little bit of a surprise and disappointment for a couple of reasons. One is about 2 days before, they traded Ryan Bates to Chicago, and Ryan was going to be the heir apparent at center. If Morse would have gotten hurt during the season, Bates would have played center. So the wisdom, conventional wisdom was, okay, they traded Bates, they're going to stick with Morse, they're going to extend his contract, to lower that cap number this year, and then move forward with him. Then they decide to cut him. So of all the guys they moved on from last week, you know, Mitch Morse was the biggest surprise. And, you know, now they're going to move Connor McGovern from left guard over to center. They signed him last year from the Cowboys. So there was a little bit of uncertainty about the reasons behind it.
Ryan, what kind of on-field personality does Morse have?
You know, one thing you see is very, very active pre-snap in terms of directing traffic. So that helps out. And, you know, one thing that stood out about Mitch last year, he gave up a half a sack in 19 games. He gave up 1.5 knockdowns in 19 games, according to my pencil. I'm not going to use Pro Football Focus for crying out loud. But, because I do my own chart. And, you know, four penalties, two of which were that snap infraction that officials start calling now. So, I thought he had a clean season. And, you know, one thing I told Hayes earlier today is you're going to talk to Mitch for the first time. You're going to think he's like a 37 or 38-year-old guy, old soul. He's only 31. And he came through the year in good health after needing an ankle surgery last offseason. So I think this was a smart pickup by the Jags.
Boy, and the things you told us about him that we didn't know, just how well he connects with people, media, community, others. That fits the culture perfectly here in a veteran presence here. Let's get to Gabe Davis, a guy that's actually from here. He's from Fernandina Beach. Ryan, the one thing they didn't have was a high point guy here, a big physical go up and get the ball guy. Now, he's 6'2", 225. I also think he's a stretch the field guy. The downside is he hasn't had that 70 or 80 catch season. What do you think of Gabe Davis and his fit here?
Well, it wasn't going to be in Buffalo. So I was looking to see where he ended up. He missed the two playoff games with a torn PCL that he hurt in the Miami game down there. He was going to try and play in the AFC title game, and I asked him, are you hitting the market? He goes, I'm hitting the market. Well, that means he was hitting the road. And right. I think this is going to be a liberating thing for Gabe. He wasn't just the second receiver in this offense this year. He was more like the fifth option behind Diggs, Knox, Kincaid, the running back side of the backfield. Then you got to Gabe. What Gabe does is scores touchdowns, 27 touchdowns out of 163 catches. What else does he do? He catches long touchdowns. This year, 35, 18, 19, 57 yards, 98-yarder last in 2022. So he just got stuck. There's only one football, as the saying goes. He started off this year well with explosive catches, but then he had a stretch where he only had 7 of those over 9 games. He got into a rut he really just couldn't get out of. So I did not expect the Bills to retain him, but also this shows you that the Jags and Ridley were far, far apart on dollars. So the Jaguars, to their credit, were proactive because this isn't a great receiver class in free agency.
Yeah, no doubt about it. So do you think, in terms of Davis, do you think it'll be difficult for him coming here in that there's going to be games where Christian Kirk gets 12 targets and Evan Engram gets 11 targets? And, you know, I don't know if we'll see about Zay Jones, but, you know, Gabe's coming here and he's going to be, I would think, at best, the third option for most games. Is that going to be a problem for him, or does that help him?
Well, I think now that he's got the contract, he'll be a little bit more able to manage it because, you know, he was a fourth-round draft pick coming out of UCF. So, I mean, the clock was ticking on him, and, you know, every game where he didn't get a lot of activity, he probably felt it was impacting his market. Now he's got the money. So I think he'll, I don't think he was ever not a team guy, but I think he'll, you know, help him manage some of that well. And, you know, he's reunited with Chad Hall, who is his receivers coach here in Buffalo for a couple of years. So I think Chad will be able to get him going pretty quickly when he gets down there.
Ryan, Trevor Lawrence and Josh Allen both struggle with turnovers. How has Josh Allen attacked it? How should Trevor attack it?
Well, it's a two-way street. You don't want to rein a thoroughbred in. These guys make as many plays out of the pocket as any of the quarterbacks in football. Josh Allen's problem is interceptions. He doesn't fumble when he's carrying it. He doesn't fumble when he's hit. So, he would come in after a win, and I would ask the first question. He would say, I'm going to get to that in a second. Let's talk about my boneheaded interception. So he's obviously aware of the takeaways. But I will defend him in this. He played turnover-free in the playoffs when you needed him to. Fortunately for them, they lost to Kansas City. If you're Lawrence, you just have to eliminate, and what coaches say, you have to eliminate the kind of interception that you make multiple times in a season, because that means you're not either not seeing it, not learning it, not correcting it. So that's the key for both players as they continue on in their careers. But I'm a Bills shouldn't trade Josh Allen for anybody who's available or draft anybody, and the Jaguars probably should be in the same boat.
Ryan O'Halloran with us talking Bills and Jags and more. Ryan, you've covered this league 21 years, but most have been AFC teams, three AFC teams now. What do you, from afar here, you know this franchise, obviously. It got better. It got better when Mitch Morris and Gabe Davis signed and Darnell Savage signed. And yet it's a brutal AFC with so many good quarterbacks and so many good coaches and so many good teams. Where does this team stack up in your mind? I don't need a power poll. I don't need a number, but just big picture. Now the Jaguars that you know got a little better today, where do they match up with these AFC teams in your mind?
Well, I'll start with the division, Frank. It's going to be very competitive, them in Houston. The Texans lost two defensive starters today, which means they didn't want to keep them. Okay, so what are the Texans plotting right now? They have all that cap space. Do they think they got the code cracked? They shouldn't think that way because this league changes from year to year. As far as the Jags, you know, their strategy last week crystallized today. So many of these teams in the league were clearing money just to get under the cap. They were clearing money to be active. And this is they weren't as active money-wise as they were in previous years, but what they did is they filled needs. They got rid of the safety, so they signed one. They weren't happy with the kicker as a free agent, they signed one. Same with the receiver, and then same with the center. So I think they upgraded a lot of positions. Tennessee giving Tony Pollard money today to cross the Titans out. I mean, I don't know what the hell they're doing. And then the Colts, sort of running in place a little bit. But, you know, this conference goes through Kansas City, and then Buffalo, Baltimore, and now I think Harbaugh is going to make the Chargers a lot better really quickly. So you're right. It's a very tough division, conference, where if you get to the Super Bowl, you got to make sure you have some bodies standing.
Absolutely. You've seen Mac Jones twice a year for a while now. What do you make of that trade?
You could tell a couple of things on the Jags front is they had extra picks, so they probably had no problem giving one of those away. And the bottom of this draft, by all accounts, is not very good. So instead of taking a guy who's not going to make your team with the sixth round pick, you take a flyer on Mac for 1 year. You know, it's not a lot of money. And, you know, if you're Mac, the Patriots failed him. But he also probably didn't help his own cause. Matt Patricia, Joe Judge fiasco 2 years ago was not fair to a young quarterback. But if you're Mac now, you go to Jacksonville, you keep your head down, you don't cause a stir, you be a good teammate, and you can make $30 million in this league if you never start another game. You could be Chad Henne. And I think that should be the goal for Mac is, hey, get ready to play. And, if you do get a chance, maybe you get another shot to start for another team.
Yeah, I think Hayes said that earlier too. Have a year here, see what happens, and then go from there. Again, it's a backup that has 42 starts compared to C.J. Beathard's 13. If you got to play a guy, play a guy that's been out there a little bit. Ryan O'Halloran checking in from Buffalo. Great work as always, Ryan. We appreciate it, man. It'll be fun to see what happens. Take care, buddy.
All right, take care now. Thanks.
All right, Ryan O'Halloran, and he knows those two cats. I loved his comments about Morris. Mm-hmm. I mean, that good guy award matters because if he's a good guy to the media, that may only matter to us. But there's not many guys that are good guys to the media but aren't great in the locker room and aren't great with their coaches and aren't great in the community. I mean, if you win that award, it's more than the media gives it, but it's way bigger than an illustration or just an affirmation of who you are to the media. It's kind of an affirmation of who you are, I think.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And I'm excited to get to know him, and I think he's going to be a fantastic addition here. Now you look at what they have on offense, and I think it's a much prettier picture today than it was 24 hours ago.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. We'll certainly keep an eye on. We'll take a break. When we come back, Scott Schroeder joins us. He's the UNF golf coach. He'll tell you all about the hate, that and more when we continue. This is 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
Here's another classic Florida Gator moment.
We got 30 minutes for the rest of our lives.
30 minutes.
We're going to hit somebody, and we're taking down the field for a touchdown. I guarantee you that.
Let's go.
Let's go.
1010XL, home of the Florida Gators.
Get ready for the Players' Championship, March 12th through 17th at TPC Sawgrass. Don't miss your chance to watch the PGA Tour's best compete to etch their name in history while enjoying a vibrant social scene.
From local bites to the latest merchandise available in the PGA Tour fan shop, The Players offers the ultimate experience for everyone to enjoy. Secure your spot today. Tickets are on sale now at theplayers.com.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top-quality custom windows and doors? Make that dream a reality with Renewal by Andersen. And right now, buy one window or patio door and get one 40% off. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires March 31st, and restrictions apply. Renewal by Andersen, the official window and door replacement partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
Calling all poker enthusiasts. Get ready for the thrill of the Run Good Poker Series. Landing at Best Bet Jacksonville from March 14th to the 24th. Brace yourself for 10 action-packed poker events, including the $1,200 no-limit hold'em main event with an incredible $300,000 guaranteed prize pool. Plus, don't miss out on event number one, the $400 no-limit hold'em tournament, featuring a $100,000 guarantee. Win your entry through exciting satellites starting March 2nd. Visit bestbetjacks.com for tournament structures and all the details. Don't miss your chance to play your hand in the Run Good Poker Series. See you at Best Bet Jacksonville.
Lauren Brooks here for Hodges Mazda. Why buy from Hodges Mazda at the Avenues? Because they strive to ensure a satisfying and comfortable car buying experience. That's why the sales staff doesn't work on commission, allowing Hodges Mazda to put your best interest first. Whether you're looking for a brand new Mazda or a pre-owned vehicle, Hodges Mazda has a large selection to help you choose from. And every vehicle purchased from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance and free car washes for life. Now that is peace of mind. So visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com.
Ahead, we build platforms for digital business. We help create your platform for digital business by weaving together advances in cloud infrastructure, intelligent operations, and modern applications. Digital business is comprised of five pillars. We call them imperatives because they're a must-have, not a nice-to-have. We enterprise cloud, integrated security, scaled DevOps, intelligent operations, and relentless automation. Need help with digital transformation? Ahead. Learn, grow, achieve.
Remember that the Big Diamond Store doesn't want you to shop and compare. They know they can't beat Beard's Diamonds prices.
Right now, it's 0% financing for 5 years, plus get zero down on everything in the store.
Don't buy anywhere until you shop Beard's Diamonds.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
I'm Jeff Middlecoff with Trustline Mortgage. My business partners, Alan Tyre, Bill Pappas, and Ken Rimley, have been helping first-time homebuyers with their mortgage financing all over Florida for 34 years. First-time homebuyers can get no or low-down payments, anywhere from 0 to 3.5% down. As a first-time homebuyer with Trustline Mortgage, you get added benefits for doing your loan with us, like lower rates on your mortgage insurance and lower closing costs. Oh, and did I forget to mention that Trustline gives first-time homebuyers better mortgage interest rates? Here's the bottom line. Trustline Mortgage wants to help first-time homebuyers accomplish your goal of home ownership. That's why Trustline Mortgage is offering the best first-time homebuyer benefits around, period. Trustline Mortgage delivers with no and low down payments, lower closing costs, and better interest rates. Call Trustline Mortgage today at 381-LOAN. That's 381-LOAN to find out how we can help you buy your dream home. Or visit our website at TrustlineMortgage.com. Trust your instincts and follow the line to Trustline Mortgage.
Certain restrictions apply. See office for details. Trustline is an equal housing opportunity. MLS number 331480.
Trivia enthusiasts, Tuesday night is your night. Gather your team and join us at Players Grill in Mandarin or Miramar for the ultimate trivia showdown. It's a whole lot of fun every Tuesday starting at 7 p.m. Are you ready to prove you're the trivia champions? Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion for QC Kinetics. This is the time of year to enjoy life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you love to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now, set up a free consultation. Call them at 904-274-5522. They've got two great locations, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra Beach. Go see them. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking lasting joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It's a fact, QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your own body's ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. So you can walk and run and climb stairs and play golf and move again pain-free. 904-274-5522. That's QC Kinetics. Call them today.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. David Tax Law. After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
This is your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update. I'm Andrew Gibson for 1010 XL. This update brought to you by J. David Tax Law. It has been a free agency frenzy today for the Jaguars, and it all started this morning with breaking news during the drill.
Well, the Jaguars have agreed to terms with center Mitch Morse. 2 years, $10.5 million deal, $7 million guaranteed, according to Mike Garofalo. Released by the Bills last week, reunites with Doug Peterson as offensive coordinator with the Chiefs. It makes me want to go into song as we welcome Freddie T to the program. Hallelujah.
Fred, you don't want to hear it song.
Hallelujah.
Mitch Morse, just one of a flurry of Jaguars moves made today. Morse was a Pro Bowl center for the Bills in 2022. It's 65 degrees at 4 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010 XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
It is a Best Bet Monday here on The Frangie Show live at Sawgrass. About to say hello to Scott Schroeder, the UNF men's golf coach. First one to tell you, satellites all week into event number one in the main event of the Run Good Poker Series at Best Bet Jacksonville. Event number one is a $400 no-limit hold'em of the Run Good Poker Series with a $100,000 guarantee that kicks off Thursday at noon at Best Bet Jacksonville. All right, Scott, can you give us a little play-by-play of what's going on here at the Hate?
Well, first off, we're supposed to be still playing, but my players decide to not play as well as we like this week, so we're getting to watch these last couple of groups finish with you all on the radio. So we're going to try to not make this a habit. First time we've had to do it before the golf finishes, but we got Cannon Clay come on the last hole from Alabama. He needs a birdie to force a playoff with Devin Patel from Virginia.
Okay.
And the team championship should be clinched, I believe, by North Carolina. So be pretty cool then. They're the number one or two team in the country, so getting a win here for them is a nice week.
Yeah, they're really good, and obviously Alabama's here. They just lost to Nick Dunlop, who best player in the country. You've had him here. You've had Gordon Sargent here. You've had Nick Gabrielczyk, who plays for you. Some of the greatest college golfers in the country played this thing, don't they?
Yeah, we've had a really nice run of good players. I mean, this year I think we have six or seven of the top 15 amateurs in the world here, so that's some pretty good golf.
That's really good golf. Tell me about this. I know John Haidt's a friend. He's a friend to so many of our charities and so many of us. This is, you were telling me, the 17th year you've had this event here. Why is this event so special to you, Scott?
You know, having been able to play at UNF, you know, I wasn't a very good player, you know, to be brutally honest. So being a part of it, and then, you know, really more so just being able to do what John does for our community and represent his name. You know, that part of this change we made this year, we added a lot of different sponsors, and the goal was the longevity of John's name around this event. And, you know, we got, I think 33 different people have supported us in different ways and different levels. And Arizona Ice Tees come on board with Chris Bird, and it's really made it even more special. So we were able to have a few more events, and it's really all just revolves around what we think is the right thing for John.
You told us last week in the practice round the wind really didn't blow. Did that translate? Did it pick up,
yeah,
and did it create a different course?
Yeah, we've had three different wind directions in 3 days. We had about an inch of rain in about 12 minutes, it felt like, on Friday. So we got Cannon Claycomb's chip for – actually, if it goes in, he would win, but it's about 6 feet short. So we got that to force a playoff. So it's been
exciting.
Yeah, it's
not like a golf TV guy right there. Yeah. This is his next career.
Well, I mean, if they pay more, you never know. Right? Sorry, Nick Morrow. But no, I mean, we've had the golf course is really held up with all the rain and the wind we've had. But it's neat because these kids are one of the reasons the coaches like it is the Q school that's here in December, and so they're exposing these elite kids to where they want to get to, which is the Korn Ferry Tour and then ultimately the PGA Tour. So seeing it in different winds, a few of the coaches are like, this is awesome experience for our players and what they want to do down the road.
How do you address your team after, you know, the performance for you a little bit disappointing?
Yeah, I mean, that's the worst event we've played all year. I told somebody, I think Nick asked me earlier, I said it's probably one of the two or three worst we've ever had in this event. And I use this term a lot with my guys. That sometimes that's just sports. We got to learn from it. Sometimes you need humbleness in this part of the season. It's like a bad loss in the middle of the season. And, you know, ultimately all of our major goals are still intact that we want to accomplish this year. These guys want to make the NCAA finals again. I got a couple seniors that want to get back there. They want to see if they can play well enough at finals to maybe make match play. And those don't go away, but hopefully it resharpens them a little bit for what they need to do on a day-in and day-out basis to be ready for that.
Yeah, one of the reasons you're disappointed, you have a really good team. We talked about this last week. Let me ask you this. For Scott said he wasn't a good player, but Scott's actually a very good golfer. But for a 12 handicap hack like me, when East West blows, it's a really hard course. Yep. I mean, a good player like you probably plays to a zero, whatever you play. Do you feel that way too?
It's hard, and the line it just gets going the wrong direction is really small out here. Yeah. And I think that's a little bit like for us this week. I mean, I got a couple guys. It's their first time being in our lineup in this event, and you know, they just built it up to be too much. It's still just golf. And ultimately, that's like what you have to do is you got to make the moment smaller so that way you can stay relaxed and hopefully be successful. And this place is just, you know, when it gets going bad, the brain is part of the problem.
Yeah. I mean, I was out here. I think I told you this the other day. I was out here as a kid when Mark Hayes won here at plus one.
Yep.
He won the players at plus. Hayes, I don't know if you remember the story. You know the story, mm-hmm. bro. He won the players on this course, yeah. East West here, at plus one over. Yeah. You know, and the players are better now, but still, it's amazing stuff.
It is amazing stuff. What's it like to recruit this area with all the talent and the facilities that you have to work with?
I mean, you're still recruiting for us at UNF is always still a bit of a guessing game, right? Like I'm not getting a kid over Alabama. I'm not getting him over Florida or Florida State. You're trying to find a guy that's maybe had some good finishes, but you think can be something better 2 years from now. And you know, the good news is in Jacksonville, we have a lot of kids that want to play college golf. We have a lot of good instruction. Kids are hopefully a little bit better prepared for it. But you also got to find kids that are tougher. And, you know, sometimes I always tell people, I don't recruit West Palm. Okay, West Palm kids typically aren't very tough, don't fit my school model for what I need to have. So it's, you know, it's a giant guessing game. I've been pretty fortunate to be a good guesser. Let's be honest, it's probably similar to the NFL draft, right? They're guessing who they think is going to turn into the good players. And you're looking for characteristics and work ethic and how they handle their business and just see how it works out.
What did you see in Nick?
He hit the middle of the club face a lot. Okay, he was a lanky kid. It wasn't the most conventional golf swing. But every time I watched him, the ball was coming out of the middle of the club face a lot. And he was highly competitive. And, I my guys know I hate losing, and I know I want kids that hate losing as much as anything. If you're okay with losing and it doesn't bother you, then we're probably not going to be a very good fit.
Is the transfer portal as rampant in men's golf as it is in some of the other sports?
Probably not as rampant. It's existing, though. I think when we get fully past all the COVID stuff, it's slowing down a little bit. But kids are, you know, some kids – we got Cannon putting to force a playoff here, so if we want to turn around and watch that, he's got about 6 feet.
How will it break?
Should go a little bit from his right to left.
This is good stuff here.
Ooh, missed it low.
It did go right, yeah. Left.
Yeah, he read it. It looks like he read it to go left to right, and it went a little left to right to left. So,
we call that on the amateur side. You good golfers don't say that, probably,
no.
Right?
pretty good story. Cannon and his brother from Louisville, I arranged the first round. They got to play back-to-back. So they've never played in a college event the same week. And one played one and one played two. So that was pretty neat for the parents to be able to watch both kids side by side.
Scott, final thing. Tell us about the rest of the golf season now for UNF, for everybody. How's it? What are the plans? What are your expectations?
So we play in Myrtle Beach next week. Be a good event. Coastal Carolina hosts. We're a little bit shorthanded there. Nick's playing in the Valspar. So anybody that wants to watch the Valspar the week after the Players, he'll be down there. And then after that, we get to play in Virginia's event, and then we go to ASUN, and then regional. So it's, I mean, everything that I'm doing now is all about May, yeah. And trying to figure out who needs to be our four or five guys and just be ready for what matters the most.
Play well at the end of the season like any other sport. Scott Schroeder, the terrific golf coach here at UNF. Scott, thanks, buddy.
Thanks for having me on.
Back in a moment, live from Sawgrass after this.
Because radio is supposed to be fun.
Feels kind of like the first day of spring training for Little League here.
1010XL.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Did you hear what's happening? Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet are spring cleaning. New inventory on the ground means we need to make more room. Take advantage of huge savings on thousands of vehicles priced to sell. New and pre-owned prices have been reduced, and all sales associates have been instructed to give maximum value on all trades. But you better hurry. The best deals go first. Head to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine
or Beaver
Chevrolet in Jacksonville to take advantage of our spring cleaning sale. We're here to wow you.
Frank Franzi here for Stanley Pools. There's a reason so many of my friends and our listeners have had Stanley Pools build their pools and now maintain their pools, because Stanley Pools truly cares about their customers. Stanley Pools is locally owned and has been serving our community for 35 years. For all of your pool needs, call Stanley Pools at 269-7277. That's Stanley Pools, a family tradition of fine swimming pools. 269-7277, or find them online at stanleypoolsfl.com.
Pickett here. The Borland Groover Foundation proudly presents the annual March to Get Screened 5K race and 1 mile fun run. Sunday, April 14th, the race starts at 7 a.m. under the Fuller Warren Bridge. Their mission, raise awareness about colorectal cancer and related deaths. All proceeds benefit the Borland Groover Foundation. It's a nonprofit organization devoted to building a healthy and equitable community that is free from colon cancer. Visit BorlandGrooverFoundation.com for more.
Jimerson Burr is a full-service, Florida-based commercial law firm that has experience and capabilities to handle any legal issue a business is confronted with. Learn more about what they can do for you at JimersonFirm.com.
Hey, sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. If you're still in the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is a one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with a real-life Vegas experience right from the comfort of your phone. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the MyBookie website. Sign up now and take advantage of a generous welcome bonus on your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200, get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun doesn't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide who to put your money on. The best part about MyBookie, you can bet on anything, anytime, from anywhere. Use promo code 1010XL to secure your welcome bonus today. Only with my book.
If you never saw Zeppelin live, now you can know what it's like. And if you did, relive the magic of Led Zeppelin Live.
Hey, mama, see the way you move.
Get the Let Out is back at Florida Theater, March 15th. Get the Let Out. Find out what it felt like to see Zeppelin live. Get tickets now at FloridaTheater.com.
Sometimes the most important position in sports needs a translator.
I'm Denny Thompson, and they call me the quarterback whisperer.
He shares his insights Friday mornings on The Drill. Brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security and George Moore Chevrolet.
This is Hayes Carlion for Kingfish Pest Control. Look, we've got to break free of pest infestation, and Kingfish Pest Control has helped me do that. They can help you do that. They've helped out a ton of my neighbors. And I tell you what, if it comes to ants, termites, mosquitoes, any annoying pests, Kingfish Pest Control is who you need to go to. Trust me, you'll get exceptional service and understand why your neighbors and I use Kingfish Pest Control, proud partner of the Jaguars.
I was on the go, it was time to eat. I said, baby, Grandma Danny, cause they can't be beat. Well, she got something else when it was time to choose. And after just one bite, I got that soggy sandwich blue. Should've known better, only Danny will do. Got that hometown flavor creeping up on you. Yeah, she done me wrong. Didn't get my dandy. I need my ham and cheese.
That's all he wanted. That's all he wanted.
Should've known better. Only dandy will do. Got that hometown flavor creeping up on you. Yeah.
Rollin', 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 we're all callin', rollin', the toilet's overflowin', oh my.
When hairball
walls, grease, and goo just won't let that water through. You need Roland Reisch Plumbing by your side. When you have got a leak and you just can't wait a week, call 260-7059. Roland Reisch Plumbing.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. I'm all
right. It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
It is a Best Bet Monday here on the Frangie Show. Again, event number one, a $400 no-limit hold'em of the Run Good Poker Series with a $100,000 guarantee kicks off Thursday at noon at Best Bet Jacksonville. Satellites all week into event number one and the main event of the Run Good Poker Series at Best Bet Jacksonville. And don't miss the $360 no-limit hold'em ladies-only championship at Best Bet Jacksonville next week. All right, gentlemen, as far as the quarterbacks are concerned, we wondered when the Kirk Cousins deal would be done. Today is the first day of legal tampering. Well, the Falcons signed good old Kirk to a $180 million contract over 4 years. That includes a $50 million signing bonus. So, Frank, once again, Kirk Cousins gets paid a lot of money.
And that's going to be a really interesting team to watch because they've got Bijan Robinson. They've got really good receivers. They're close. Raheem Morris is a guy that is really respected around the league, one of the young, bright coaches. There's been a real move to hire tough-nosed defensive coaches as head coaches now. And Kirk Cousins has something left. He's 35. He seems like a young 35 to me. He got paid as everybody knew that he would. That'll be a very intriguing team to watch, I think, Hayes.
Yeah, I think they go right to the top of that division. I think they're going to be expected to unseat Tampa Bay there. And Tampa Bay obviously brought back Baker Mayfield, so that division, which is probably the worst in football, getting some good firepower. But I think Cousins to Atlanta made all the sense in the world. And, you know, I commend Arthur Blank, the Falcons owner, for getting this done because I'm sure there was a lot of resistance from Minnesota. And to be able to sway Kirk Cousins at this stage of his career to have his final act in Atlanta, it's a huge win for Atlanta. And it's a huge win for Kirk Cousins, even beyond the money. I mean, he's going to have a ground game that can certainly help him. He's going to have an outstanding receiver in Drake London, big target. And if this doesn't unleash Kyle Pitts, nothing will.
Yeah.
I think it makes all the sense in the world for Kirk Cousins to play well there immediately. And I think it puts Atlanta in the mix to win that division and host a playoff game.
Yeah, I like the signing for Atlanta. I thought all along they would go with Justin Fields, a little bit younger guy, a little bit more mobile. But I think Kirk Cousins will play really well for them, and I bet he's excited to go there with that offensive firepower. So then the questions become, what do the Vikings do, and what or where does Justin Fields end up?
Those are the two, aren't they? Those are the two follow-up questions. Number one, who quarterbacks the Minnesota Vikings? And number two, who lands Justin Fields? And I'll make a number three, is it the Minnesota Vikings? I don't think so, but I mean, certainly the Vikings need a quarterback now. The Vikings actually have a pretty good team. They may have the best receiver in football. They got a good young offensive-minded coach. Who quarterbacks the Minnesota Vikings?
Gardner Minshew?
Maybe someone who's won games in the league, right?
I would think it's going to be a similar deal for Minshew as
Sam
last
Darnold
year.
Sam Darnold, too, maybe? Sam Darnold
could
in play?
Be. But I think that kind of a veteran bridge guy that – can hopefully keep them afloat, and you got to think Minnesota at 11 is thinking quarterback and maybe trying to even get ahead of some teams to get into that top three, but that's going to be awfully difficult. But you know, I would think that if I was J.J. McCarthy, I would be pretty confident in thinking I'm not getting past the 11th selection.
Yeah, I think that's actually a good plan for them to have a guy like Gardner Minshew, who's, in my opinion, kind of a poor man version of Kirk Cousins, and then to be able to draft a quarterback, especially if they move up. I mean, to me, Michael Penix Jr. is going to be good in the league. We'll see. I've been wrong before, but I think his playing style translates really well, and so you give him a guy like Justin Jefferson. Obviously, he had really good weapons at Washington as far as receivers are concerned. I think that would work well.
It'll be interesting to see. Which gets us to Justin Fields. Let's assume, at least for the sake of this conversation, because I do think it's going to happen, the Bears do try to move him, and with the plan being to draft Caleb Williams. I think most people expect that, and I do as well. Now where to for Justin Fields? I always kind of thought because he's from there and because they need a quarterback and because they're close, I thought at the end of the day he would wind up with the Falcons, and now that's off the table. Where does Justin Fields land?
I don't know. There were reports this weekend that were saying that his compensation is really low. Like, yeah, the teams just aren't interested in adding him at any sort of, you know, second, third round value. Yeah. Yeah. So that was really surprising to me. So that clouds it, because if you don't really believe in him, I mean, then where does he fit in? So if the compensation is that low, honestly, Chicago should keep him and just have Caleb Williams be the starter day one. Don't do this alternating days crap in training camp, but make Caleb Williams the starter and Justin Fields is your backup, and then go from there. And at least you know you've got a really good backup. That's tough on Justin because he was trying to be the leader there, and now a rookie comes in and pushes him out. So it's not ideal, but I mean, I don't know that I would trade Justin Fields for a fifth round pick. I mean, to me, he's got more value than that. So, but if there's no suitors out there that are willing to give you the second or the third, then maybe you keep him.
The veteran teams that looked like they needed a veteran quarterback were the Falcons. They've now got theirs. The Steelers, they've now got theirs. The Raiders still qualify, I think. The Vikings still qualify. Not, I'm talking about young teams that we know are going to draft quarterbacks. I'm talking about teams that look like they're positioned to go get veteran quarterbacks. Vikings and Raiders are the ones that are left, with the Steelers off the board and the Falcons off the board, right?
Yeah. What do you think about the Steelers, Russell Wilson?
You know, it seems like he fits there to me. I told you I didn't think Gardner Minshew fit there. I don't know why. I just feel like this is a heritage franchise that if they were going to get a veteran, needed to get a heritage veteran. This is a 7-time Pro Bowler and a Super Bowl winner that should have 2 rings. And I just that one seemed like didn't it feel like it fit? We talked about it last week when all the buzz on our Friday show was that that's where it was going to land. I think it fits. I'm not sure he's great anymore. In fact, I'm sure he's not great anymore. I'm not sure how good he is anymore. I think the Steelers have a good defense. I think they have a woeful offense. I know you love George Pickens, and you're probably right. If he ever gets going, he has a wealth of talent. But I think their other weapons are just okay. I think the backup running back's better than the starter. I think the line's okay. So it's not like Russ Wilson's going to this loaded team. I think he's going to a team with a very good defense. So we'll see. Does it elevate the Steelers into the mix with all those good AFC teams? Not for me, it doesn't.
I think it does.
Do you?
For me, yeah. And it's such a meager, I mean,
well, now Russell
deal.
Wilson,
I mean,
Russell Wilson 7 years ago might.
I think Russell Wilson, I mean, again, I think that, you know, his first year he's with Hackett, last year he's with Peyton, and it's almost two extremes there. I don't think he's going to salvage himself into Pro Bowl form or anything like that, but I think the environment's pretty good for him in terms of playing. What was he this year, 26 touchdowns, 10 picks, something like that? Well, that's a heck of a lot better than what Pittsburgh had combined with Pickett and
the
Rudolph.
Quarterback, the quarterbacks were terrible.
I mean, if he gives Pittsburgh 27 touchdown passes and 8 interceptions.
Was he
26 and 8.
26 and 8.
He was.
If he does
that's
that,
better than I realized.
If he does that in Pittsburgh, they'll make the playoffs.
They'll be a good team. You're right.
And a loaded AFC.
Deal.
Yeah.
To me, the Steelers went from like completely out of it to now with this move, like they're back in. Like it never made sense when they were talking about before the combine it was going to be Pickett and Rudolph.
Right.
It was like, what are you doing? This is at least – this sort of fell into the lap. But to their credit, they took advantage of it.
Oh, the veterans – yeah, it's cost them nothing.
It cost them nothing.
$1 million.
Yeah, the veteran minimum because the Broncos have to pay so much.
Yeah, the I guess for me, I never saw them in the Cousins Derby. Yeah, I mean, we'll see. Obviously, it's heritage team joined by heritage player, which that – so the storylines are fantastic. The league loves to give the Steelers – 5 primetime games anyway. It's a good thing now there's a limit, because with Russ in that uniform, they'd give him 10 if they could. You know, so I certainly think that. Other teams, I agree with something Ryan O'Halloran said. The Titans signed Tony Pollard to a big deal. Homer alert here, so I'm going to preface it. That's my disclaimer. Is Tony Pollard really significantly better? I know he's younger, significantly better, and I know he's different, than Derrick Henry?
No, that's a bad signing.
Wouldn't you think?
Honestly, to this point.
Keep Derrick Henry on a one-year deal or whatever.
I haven't been the least bit worried about anything an AFC South team has done.
Yeah.
I mean, now I don't know. Maybe that's changed. I haven't picked up my phone in the last 40 seconds.
Yeah.
So maybe the Texans or Colts just spent big. But I had zero problem with the Colts signing Pittman to a long-term deal because I think he's overrated. I had zero issue with the Titans signing Pollard. Because to your point, I think they got worse at running back. And the Texans have been quiet, which I wouldn't think, you know, that stays the course. But at least for now, I mean, Wilkins is off the board. He's a Raider. That was, you know, that's certainly a win for the Jaguars. Saquon Barkley is an Eagle. He's off the board. So you look at some of the bigger names, and so far Houston is I'll say this. If I was – in Houston, I'd be asking, what the heck are they doing? I mean, you got top five cap space, and you're not a player for any of these guys? Like, I mean, or you're at least not getting the deal done. Maybe you're a player, but you're not, you know, you're not drinking the coffee here. So why are they not closing deals? I mean, it's great for the Jaguars, but I'm surprised the Texans have been so quiet so far, and again, I may be saying this as they've announced.
No, Schefter's reporting that they may sign DeNico Autry, who's a good player, and it weakens
Jeff
the Titans
for a 1 year deal.
Yeah, so I'm with you though. I'm a little put off by how good how quickly the Texans got pretty good with DeMeco Ryan, C.J. Stroud, and others, those fast receivers. But nothing they've done since the season ended has concerned me. That's your point, I think. Yeah, I don't
know. No John Grenard because he's off to the Vikings.
Who's a good player? Mm-hmm. He's a better player than I thought he'd be coming out of Florida. So I think he's a pretty good player. We'll see. Back to Fields for a second. Having said all that, I don't think the Bears are going to keep him. I think he's going to go somewhere else. But I'll be darned if I can figure out where. I think the Patriots are drafting a quarterback. I think the Commanders, obviously, and the Bears are drafting a quarterback. A lot of the teams with more veteran teams, we just talked about this, now have their quarterback. I'm trying to figure out where
I mean, if you're the Giant, let's just say it's the compensation has fallen and it's a fourth round pick.
Yeah.
If you're the Giants, do you send it just to have some insurance for Daniel Jones?
Or the Jets. Like if Aaron Rodgers goes down again.
Yeah.
You don't have a backup quarterback.
But maybe you're onto something. Maybe that's what happens. Maybe he winds up being an insurance. You both made a good point. Maybe he winds up being an insurance policy.
I would take him if I was the Raiders. I mean, if the Raiders could.
That's the one.
I would even send him a third round pick for Fields.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it may be tied up in a condition or something, but I mean, I think Justin Fields is certainly above average.
There's still stuff that's unlocked there, isn't there?
Justin Fields, Davante Adams.
Yeah, I don't know how good Justin Fields is, but I think there's more there than we've seen. See, with a young quarterback, it's not just what he's accomplished. It's what's in there that we haven't seen yet. And I think he's a guy that I think qualifies as a what's in there that we haven't seen.
Well, especially when you have had a really bad offensive line and not great weapons for said quarterback. And that's what the situation's been like in Chicago for Fields. So it seems almost unfair to be like, okay, with Caleb now we're going to start, you know, giving him a better offensive line and better weapons. And Fields, you never got that.
Are the Seahawks in play?
They could be.
I mean,
they should be, but they seem like they're Geno Smith.
Yeah. For now. I mean, I'm going around in my mind. I'm going around the league, trying to see who.
Geno Smith. I mean, if I was the Seahawks, I would have some interest in Fields, particularly if they've come down on what they're looking for.
Because there's not much doubt in any of our minds, right? The Bears, Commanders, Patriots are taking those three guys.
That's
whether Drake
May
drops to third or stays second. Yeah. Those three guys, Caleb Williams, Jaden Daniels, and Drake May, are going to those three teams. I think there's less mystery in those three, right, than we've had at the top three in a long time.
Yeah, I would be surprised. You know, again, if you're Arizona, you know, what's your confidence level with Kyler Murray? The problem is –
Now, that one's interesting.
If you trade for Fields, it's certainly a shot across the bow in terms of the confidence you have in your, quote, franchise guy. So if you're the Giants, the Cardinals, and you've got a starter that's teetering on whether he's the answer, if you make a move like this, the signal is, well, you know, we're sort of thinking you might not be. And so we want to have a young player ready to put in there. But, I think the Raiders is the clearest path for him to play because he'd beat out Aiden O'Connell in about 2.5 practices would be my guess. So.
Yeah. That
would be the cleanest.
That might be the one.
But the Raiders may look at him and say, We're not interested.
And, with Russell Wilson and Kirk Cousins obviously off the board, Gardner Minshew's still out there for somebody. I think the Raiders would be better with Minshew than they would Fields. I that sounds crazy.
I'd probably trade Fields over signing Minshew. I wouldn't discount signing Minshew. I would rather have Minshew than Aiden O'Connell.
Yeah, and by the way, I almost got the impression talking to Denny, and I know he doesn't know, but he's close to Gardner. I think he's with him in Naples this week. I almost get the impression he's going back to Indy. Do you get that sense? That's a possibility, isn't it?
Unless Minnesota is really interested, then that might make some sense. But, yeah, I mean, again, it's a game of musical chairs, and a lot of the chairs are occupied right now.
Yeah, I guess they are. Interesting stuff. All right, we'll take a break. Later on, Nick Morrow joins us, the AD here at UNF. Let's talk a little college basketball. It's been all football. We'll update you on any of the news that comes in. It's been a football day for sure. But a little college hoops over the weekend. We'll talk about that. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
There's no business like show business.
Now, this is serious business here, man.
The Drill.
We've got a mission.
Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser.
Putting on a great show is the most important thing you can do.
Mornings on 1010XL.
Get ready, get set, and go to the Ready, Set, Go sales event going on now at Arlington Toyota. Arlington Toyota is loaded with fresh, new Toyota inventory. And right now, you can get interest rates as low as 4.9% for 72 months on select new Toyotas. Plus, get credit help with Arlington's pre-approval program. And every new Toyota comes with Arlington's lifetime warranty. It's the Ready, Set, Go sales event in person, 10939 Atlantic Boulevard, and online at arlingtontoyota.com.
Hey, sports fans, it's Hayes Carlion for QC Kinetics. Listen, the state of healthcare is always changing. And old ideas like steroids and surgery, they're no longer your only options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative, non-surgical, drug-free treatments that deliver lasting results. Knee pain, back pain, shoulder pain, arthritis, injury. Don't let this pain keep you from living your best life. Give them a call at 904-274-5522 to set up a free consultation at either the Mandarin or Ponte Vedra locations. Again, that's 904-274-5522. Hips, shoulders, elbows, they can all be treated with natural biologics from your own body. Powerful healing agents, highly concentrated. QC Kinetics' advanced state-of-the-art treatments harness and direct your body's natural ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Give them a call today, 904-274-5522. That's QC Kinetics.
Hey, it's Hicken with 1010XL. The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is currently hiring for police, corrections, 911 dispatchers, and various civilian jobs. And for a limited time, JSO offering a hiring incentive up to $10,000 for police and corrections applicants. Details available at joinjso.com. Start your journey as a law enforcement professional, helping us drive down crime and foster positive relationships with citizens. If you're ready to be part of the solution, apply now. The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is an equal opportunity, equal access employer.
Get ready for the Players' Championship, March 12th through 17th at TPC Sawgrass. Don't miss your chance to watch the PGA Tour's best compete to etch their name in history while enjoying a vibrant social scene. From local bites to the latest merchandise available in the PGA Tour fan shop, the Players offers the ultimate experience for everyone to enjoy. Secure your spot today. Tickets are on sale now at theplayers.com.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On March 11, 1941, Hall of Famer Bronco Nagurski regains the world wrestling title from Ray Steele after losing a year prior.
If you are having problems related to selling your home, here's your solution. You just have not discovered ChadAndSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. Listen, maybe the problem is you need more space for your office or growing family, or perhaps you're worried about settling for less money with a lowball instant offer. We've got one guarantee here that always rings true. Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. It's as simple as that. So you need to call 904-414-6200 or go to chadandsandy.com like Jonathan in Mount Pleasant did. The only thing standing between me and my dream of traveling in my RV was the sale of my Mount Pleasant home. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called. Crazy results. In just 3 days, I received multiple offers for full asking price. So you don't have the problems you think you do. You have solutions and promises with Chad and Sandy. Go to chadandsandy.com or call 904-414-6200 at chadandsandy.com.
Men suffering from erectile dysfunction or PE, frustrated taking pills that don't work. Here's a message from Prime Men's Medical Center.
I'm Dr. Simovitz. Prime Men's Medical Center offers breakthrough treatments with men lasting longer than ever without pain or surgery.
Call now. Your consultation and first treatment are free. You'll see instant results right in the office. Call Prime Men's Medical Center now. 904-664-8217. That's 904-664-8217.
Now that's what I call high quality H2O.
If you want high quality H2O in your home, call your local water boy, Keith, at Kenai Water Jacksonville. That's K-E-N-A-I Water Jacksonville.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. I had another aha moment last week when walking through the grocery store. I stood in the aisle and laughed out loud while looking at what I used to buy. And that's an overlooked but critical benefit of Awaken 180 Weight Loss. It changes the way you look at food. You embrace the good and avoid the bad because both your mind and body are reshaped using the program Mike Dempsey and I have had so much success with. I lost 40 pounds with Awaken 180 Weight Loss, and it begins and ends with a program that encourages you to eat. That's right, eat 6 times a day. Awaken 180 Weight Loss also gives you a personal coach who helps you through the process and has answers to every possible question. Because they've succeeded with the program, too. They make sure you stay the course and reach your weight loss goals, and here's the key, keep it off for life. Get your initial consultation on the calendar this month and get ready to change your life with a proven plan that more than 20,000 have successfully used. It's fast, it's easy, and it's free support for life. Reserve online at awaken180weightloss.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Josie's on a vacation far away.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
All right, over the weekend, Florida played its last regular season game of the season. Yeah, that makes sense. Last regular season game of the season. Florida lost to Vanderbilt, Frank, 79-78. And once again, the story, I would say, turnovers league.
Yeah, they listen, it's a hard sport. All right, it's the best league in America. I really believe that. Or certainly maybe the Big 12 is the best, but it's a really good league. It's as good a league as it's ever been. They have grinded through. They have had very few clunkers. Almost none, really. Almost no really bad performances. Maybe the A&M. Maybe the end of the game, the home game against Georgia, where they had to come back and win in overtime. But they haven't had very many. They didn't play very well in this game. The bottom line is they didn't. They got out tough. They got out fought. Now, the absolute phantom call at the end of the game on Tyrese Samuel, that was one of the worst calls you'll ever see. It was an official, I think, got caught up in the Cinderella moment. And if it's not called and it shouldn't have been, Florida still wins. It's 78-75. There's 20 seconds left in the game. Samuel's about to pass it to Pullen. He's an 86% free throw shooter. They're in the double bonus. He's going to make at least one. It's a two-possession game. Teams get the ball down two possessions with 19 seconds. So they would have won the game. But it happens. It's almost better. If they lose the spot, if they go from a 6 seed to a 7 seed, maybe that hurts them. But so they play a 10 instead of an 11. I don't know. It may be a way to get their attention because I thought they were – that's as close as they've been to asleep at the wheel, a little bit sloppy as they have been in 2 months, I think.
Yeah, it was to your point, they were due for a clunker and this was it. I think it affected them 2 seeds. I think they went from 6 seed to – I think they're now back in the 8-9 range. Their net really took a big hit. As it should, and part of their allure, I think, to the committee was that they had no bad losses. Their worst loss this year was a road loss at Ole Miss, which is a quad 2 loss. So, you know, now you take on a loss in the quad 3 element. So, you know, I think from a seeding standpoint, it hurts them. But in the long term, looking at things, you know, I think they were never going to move off the 6th line for the SEC seed. Once they lost to South Carolina on the road, they were pretty much assured they weren't going to get the double bye. So it's not like the loss cost them anything there. Had they won, they still would have been the sixth seed. And frankly, I think they're in by far the best half of the SEC bracket for them. So if it's is it worth losing to Vanderbilt and knowing that you're going to not have the double bye anyway, is it worth it to at least be on a side of the bracket with Alabama, who plays zero defense, Kentucky, who plays zero defense. Now, they're two of the best offenses in the country, but from a matchup standpoint, Florida can handle that. But what Florida, and this isn't something that can be solved now, and it's probably going to be the day their season ends, the prevailing theme from the loss, they're not tough. Now, you rarely have great offense and toughness. That's really hard to find in basketball, so you kind of know you're going to sacrifice some toughness when you're going to be so offensively built. But, I mean, there was probably 8 or 9, I'm not talking 50-50 balls, like 70-30 balls, where Florida absolutely should have had the rebound and couldn't come up with it. And they missed dunks, they missed layups, and look, you lose by one. To Vandy's credit, they were 19 of 20 from the line. They were plus 6 rebounding despite not having a starter above 6'8". I mean, that just tells you all you need to know about the, how lackadaisical Florida was. And Vandy was plus 8 on turnovers. Florida committed 16. So Vanderbilt played the cleaner game. They certainly got the huge call at the end. And, you know, we'll see if, you know, anything that's one that's really tough because it just absolutely does. I mean, Vanderbilt deserved to win, but, boy, that – I mean – it's one thing to make that miss a call like that when there's 7 minutes left in
the
game,
right?
But to miss it in the final 25 seconds,
yeah, especially when you let guys get rebounds, you rarely, almost never see a rebounding foul in the last minute of a game. If you do, it has to be egregious.
Well, and to your point that you've made many times, he didn't see it because it didn't happen.
Correct.
So he called something thinking it had happened, having not seen it happen. The guy just was flying in for a rebound.
Right.
And his momentum took him under the basket. And the official assumed, well, he must have been pushed
when
he clearly wasn't.
And
so,
Samuel's right arm moved that way because he's blocking out. So you could, but again, the biggest thing, to your point, and what I've said many times, what bothers me more in officiating, I don't mind if something happens, an official misses, unless it's egregious. But I don't mind something happened, an official didn't see it. They're human. They're gonna not see some things. You're human. You can't see everything. I do mind when an official calls something he thinks he might have seen. And that's what that was. That was a guy calling something he thought he might have seen because he didn't see it happen because it didn't happen. That was the one that – but again
– can we get a coach's challenge? Like,
yeah.
Just like we kind of have –
I'd love to see that.
They're
reviewing everything anyway.
Correct. They review it for flavor and stuff.
I mean, the first game that – well, I don't even remember who – South Carolina, Mississippi State? I mean, they were reviewing, like, the ball dribbled once or twice.
Right. So we're watching that game, and I'm texting with Hayes – because Hayes loves it when I lose my mind on this. South Carolina is up on Mississippi State by 3. The game's going to end on time. We're actually going to see the beginning of the Florida-Vanderbilt game. Okay? The only way we can miss tip, the only way is if, A, Mississippi State hits an off-balance 3, or
South Carolina
fouls him while shooting the 3. Happened overtime. Then it happens again.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, are you kidding me? So we got the game with 8 minutes left in the half. And by the
8:40.
Way, and apparently there's a difference between SEC Plus and ESPN app because people at the SEC Plus had it. I never got it. I kept getting game hadn't started yet.
I never got it.
Did you?
I had to watch the first part of Florida's game on my phone while South Carolina Mississippi State finished.
Okay, so you did watch it on your phone.
I couldn't get it on my phone.
I could not get it on my phone. If I would have been fine if I could have got it. I could not get, at least you got it. So you must have something different than I've got.
Well, this is where I think Florida is now because I do think that's a terrible loss, and I do think it knocks them down to like the 8-9 range. I mean, again, their net's 35.
Yeah.
So, I mean, for them to get a 7 seed, the committee would have to basically say, this is one of the top 28 teams. Well, that's 7 spots better than what the metric is going to tell the committee, the main metric that they use. Now, the good news is if you beat the Georgia-Missouri winner on Thursday night, which they should, I think you go to a 7. And if you beat Alabama, which I think they will, on Friday, then I think you go to a 6. Now, I don't think that they're going to – I think they'll lose to Kentucky in the semifinal, but although they certainly could win it.
Yeah.
But I think that they'll, by selection Sunday, I think they're going to have a good week. I think 2-1 is what they're going to end up
doing.
That gets them
to a six. They beat Alabama again. They'll be a six seed.
That's what I would think. Yeah, so I still think they can get there, but now they've got a little bit of work cut out, I think, to avoid the 8-9.
Yeah. So you get to a 6 or 7, we'll see. But I will tell you, Clayton had a bad game. He hasn't had very many of them. He had a bad game. But I thought Florida can't have a second half where they don't make a three. Now that's the one thing I think's on Todd Golden.
Right.
He as good a coach as he is, he's got to draw up some automatic three looks. I mean, they only took three shots. They were 0-for-3 from the arc in the second half. The three distresses me more than the 0. You take 0-3s in the second and expect to win. Even though they almost did, it's hard to do.
The other thing, too, I think that's a good point. The other thing that I had some issue with in terms of Golden and the team in the second half is Vanderbilt had no answer for Samuel inside. And he was on fire. He was 8-10 from the field. So, again, that's one where the 10 concerns me because Vanderbilt showed no ability to be able to stop him, yet he only takes 10 shots from the field. Well, if, you know, Clayton's struggling, I mean, they should have been going into Samuel left and right, and they really went to him here and there. But, again, 10 shots in a 40-minute game when they really had no answer for him, that was disappointing as well. But, again, it's it may end up being the best thing for him. I mean, maybe a few days of hearing about how bad they played in Nashville will lead to them playing well. I think it will. I don't think they'll win the tournament now. I just think it's too difficult an assignment with not having the double bye. But I think they have a chance to get to the final. That would be, in all likelihood, beating Alabama and Kentucky. I think more realistic for me is that they beat the bad team they see Thursday. They beat, probably in ugly fashion, but they win the game by 4 or 5 over, I'm assuming, Georgia. And then I do think they beat Alabama. And then I think Kentucky, just that crowd, I mean, it's not neutral. That whole arena will be Wildcats. And that's an awfully difficult assignment against Kentucky and their offense when it's your third game in 3 days.
News, by the way, from Ian Rappaport. The Raiders have agreed to a 2-year deal with Gardner Minshew.
Oh, there you go.
So Gardner, we talked about it a moment ago.
He's the perfect Raider.
Yes, he is. According to Ian Rappaport, Gardner Minshew to the Raiders. He will compete with Aiden O'Connell. He is clearly better than Aiden
O'Connell. Yeah, he'll start.
So he will be the start. And it's a 2-year deal.
Yeah, and they
give Gardner Minshew credit. He has toiled around. He's bounced around. He's stayed the course to have a chance to be somebody's starting quarterback. He had that for a moment here, but it didn't last very long. Now he's got it again.
Yeah, and I don't think the Raiders are – going to go quarterback. I mean, overly high. I mean, maybe Penix gets in there and, you know, maybe Nix, but I certainly don't think the Raiders are getting one of the top four guys. So I think that's a great spot for Gardner because, honestly, I do think he'll beat out O'Connell, and I don't think there'll be some rookie that, you know, ownership feels like, hey, why is this guy not out on the field? So that could end up being a really good spot for Gardner. And again, you've got weapons. I mean, Davante Adams remains at 31, one of the best receivers in the game. Assuming he doesn't lose anything in the offseason, I mean, that's a great weapon to start with. That should be 115 catches that Gardner Minshew can count in his back pocket.
Boy, if they're good, if they're even reasonably good, the AFC is stupid. You know?
Really?
I mean, if they're even reasonably,
I mean,
good.
The Patriots and Titans may not win a game.
I mean, goodness gracious! I mean, so
it's brutal.
So we'll see.
By the way, one other note as far as Ian Rappaport is concerned, in the Jaguars, All-Pro special teams player Devin Duvernay has agreed to a deal with the Jaguars. He gets a 2-year deal worth $8.5 million base upside up to $12.5 million.
That? So that's the Agnew replacement.
Yeah. So interesting stuff. Yeah, Duvernay in, and perhaps Agnew out. We will certainly see. What happens. I want to finalize football and basketball because we're back to football for the final hour of the program. We're going to kind of re-rack everything the Jags did. SEC tournament starts this week. Tip of the cap again to JU, who played very well. Stetson went on and won the A-Sun, as you would imagine, which confirms I thought all along that I think JU was going to go. JU would be in the tournament. If they made one more play after that, it'll
be interesting. Jalen Blackman, did you see? 43 points.
Yeah. Wow. And by the way, he couldn't make a shot against JU.
Correct.
He couldn't, but They have a good team. Stetson has a good team, so they've earned their way in. So let's take a break. When we come back, we got 1 hour to go. We're live at Sawgrass. We're out here for the Hate Invitational. It wrapped up about 30, 40 minutes ago. It's cleared out a little bit now. But a fun, fun golf tournament. We love coming here. We love our relationship with our friends at the University of North Florida. That's why we are here. It's always the best bet Monday. Starting tomorrow, all of our programs live from the Players' Championship right across the street. Back in a moment. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
It's Fantasy Golf at the Players, brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors.
It's got a chance.
If your golfer scored the lowest at TPC Sawgrass, win $1,000 of jewelry from Beard's Diamonds. Enter at 1010XL.com.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
This is Dr. George Barry inviting you to look online at BarryOrthopedics.com for the latest in medical advancements when it comes to getting you back to full joint health. After studying under Dr. James Andrews, I know proper diagnosis is the first key to treatment, and educating the patient is the fastest path to recovery. Whether it's chronic back pain, nagging arthritis, or necessary joint replacement, we're here to serve you in the best possible way. We are Barry Orthopedics, and online at BarryOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BarryOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I orthopedics.com.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella Windows and Doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's lucky contestant, a cheese negotiator from Jacksonville, Florida, meet Margaret Drent.
How do you like my costume, Bob? I'm Gruyere.
Well, you smell great, Margaret. But here's your question. What's wrong with your air conditioner when you hear this sound?
Oh, that's a toughie. Are you sure you don't want me to tell you the suggested retail price of a box of Rice-A-Roni?
5 seconds, Margaret.
Is it... a compressor motor starter failure?
That's right, Margaret. And if you call the coolness experts at Mueller Air Conditioning, we can fix that faulty AC to make sure that
you are cool.
Surprisingly stuffy inside a giant cheese.
You signed the waiver, Margaret.
Stay cooler with Mueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Have you tried golfing at the improved Cimarron Golf Club? If you haven't, tell you what, you're missing out on the best deal in Jacksonville. Now, many of you have received a postcard in the mail, and of course, if you bring that with you, $45 plus tax to play. That includes a cart, lunch, and a beer at the brand new Stone Barrel Tap House. Now, go to the website, that is CimarronGolfClub.com, and sign up for the Wild One Loyalty Program. That's the Wild One Loyalty Program, and get all of these specials emailed to you from Cimarron.
This is Hayes Carline for SkyLife Elite. Are you tired of canceled flights, unruly passengers, and layovers? Call my friends at SkyLife Elite. Consider using private charter flights for your next adventure. Yes, you can afford it. Make your own schedule. Fly direct. Drive your car to Craig Airport and get directly on the plane. SkyLife Elite can make that happen. Call 490-9332, go to flyskylife.com, and find them on social media. Fly SkyLife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
The flagship station of the Jaguars, WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach, WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Frank Frangie here. These days, it's hard to know which companies to trust. When it comes to banking, I trust South State Bank. South State truly values its customers, and they work hard to create meaningful, lasting relationships. I love going into my local branch. I see the same smiling faces I've seen for years. South State is the largest bank headquartered in Florida, so they're able to offer all the banking services you need. You can trust South State Bank. Banking forward. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Ready to join the team?
The Jaguars and our stadium partners are hosting a job fair Wednesday, April 3rd to find enthusiastic new faces to serve as ushers, ticket takers, concessionaires, security, and more for the upcoming season. Stop by the Fields Auto Group Terrace Suite at Everbank Stadium from 3 till 8 p.m. on April 3rd to apply. Professional dress, a pen, and a smile are all you need, so stop by the job fair to be a part of Jaguars Game Day.
Equal opportunity employer.
Whitney Cummings presents the Big Baby Tour 2024.
The crazy thing is that when you're 35 as a woman, they start calling your pregnancy geriatric. I'm sorry that the appropriate age for women to get pregnant in the medical community is at prom in a toilet. I am so glad that I waited to get pregnant. If I had got pregnant even a year earlier, I would have sold the baby for Taylor Swift tickets.
Whitney Cummings, live on stage at the Florida Theater, Saturday, November 16th. Get tickets now at floridatheater.com.
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here, and I'm happy to see so many others make the same 180 with their weight loss and start with Awaken 180 weight loss. Hacker, he's now down 25 pounds in just 2 weeks. Amazing results, lifetime results with the solution for weight loss, Awaken 180 weight loss.
Hi, I'm Lee Nimnick, 2024 tournament chairman for the Players' Championship. Thanks to support from all of you, this championship can positively impact our Northeast Florida community all year round. The Players' Championship starts tomorrow.
Get this thing unwrapped here. Duval!
Pros, what in the world are you doing working on your Duval?
That's right. Man, I really identify with Duval.
You live in St. Johns County, knucklehead.
I mean the Duval sub, the Daly's Dash Duval. Turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheeses. Lettuce, tomato, crispy and fresh, you know, like me. I'm sure there's a Daly's Dash sub that sums you up.
The boss.
Because, of course,
oven roasted beef, Munster cheese, roasted mushrooms, caramelized onions. It's the boss of all subs. Only available for me.
That's just not true.
What do you mean? I walked in the other day, screamed, "You know it," and said, "A boss for a boss."
Well, no matter who you are, there is a Daly's Dash sandwich or sub for you.
Go find yours. They may even make you a boss.
I'm sure they will, because it is Daly's Dash.
Where more is better.
And you got that right.
This is your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update. I'm Andrew Gibson for 1010XL. Here is a rundown of the reported moves made today by the Jags. A 2-year deal for former Pro Bowl center Mitch Morse. A 3-year deal for former Bills wide receiver Gabe Davis. A 3-year deal for former Packers first-round safety Darnell Savage. The Jags have reportedly agreed to a 3-year deal with former Saints Pro Bowl kicker Will Lutz. Also, a reported 2-year deal for All-Pro special teams player Devin Duvernay. Those are the reported free agent deals made today by the Jaguars. All deals become official when the new NFL league year begins on Wednesday at 4 p.m. It's 64 degrees at 4:57. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Here, that means it's time for more football.
Football!
Football at 5.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
On the Frangie Show.
All right, Nick Morrow, the UNF AD, joins us in about 20 minutes to talk about the hate. Let's now reset the football. Oh, what a busy day it's been. Hayes, take us through Jaguar activity today. At least five new Jacksonville Jaguars on this first day of legal tampering. Take us through all of them and the significance.
Yeah, it's been a great day for the Jaguars. Certainly commend Trent Baalke and Doug Peterson for getting a lot of great work done. And it started with Mitch Morse, the talented center from the Bills. He'll stabilize that offensive line, you hope. He'll certainly be a big upgrade over Luke Fortner. He's worked with Doug Peterson in the past in Kansas City. He was Patrick Mahomes' center the year he threw 50 touchdowns, his first year in the league as a starter. And he's worked with Josh Allen for the last few years. Our buddy Ryan O'Halloran joined us earlier, talked about what a great guy he is. He's been the Good Guy Award winner. He's really helped Mahomes and certainly Allen grow. And so I think he'll do wonders for Trevor Lawrence. So it starts there. That's an A++++ move. for the Jaguars. And again, it's not going to affect anything from a comp pick standpoint because he'd already been released. So he does not qualify as a free agent like some of these others do. So you go from there to Gabe Davis and going back to the Bills, a receiver that kind of never found his way, I'd say, fully in Buffalo, had some amazing games. But you look at the stats on the whole, nothing that jumps out great in terms of yards per catch. Certainly gives you a deep weapon and a physical weapon. He's a big frame guy. 27 career touchdowns, and he's going into his basically this will be year 25 for Gabe. He's a young man. So I think you like that deal in terms of him coming in here and not having to really have the pressure of being like the number one guy. Obviously, you got Christian Kirk, Evan Ingram. Darnell Savage, I think, adds a lot to the secondary. I think I was fine if they handed the keys to Antonio Johnson, but maybe they felt like that was a little quick. So I think Cisco and Darnell Savage from Green Bay become your safeties, and Antonio Johnson will give you some snaps at nickel. And Lutz, obviously, we knew they weren't bringing back McManus with the struggles he had late in the year. So Lutz steps in. He's been a kicker now for several years in the NFL. So hopefully he'll be able to provide some consistency if he wins the job. And staying with special teams, signing Devin Duvernay out of Baltimore, I mean, he's about as explosive as it comes in the return game. So as good as Jamal Agnew was here, this is, I'd say, even a slight upgrade from Jamal Agnew. This is somebody that has a dazzling career punt return average. It's around 12 yards a pop. And has returned a couple kicks in his career for touchdowns. So he doesn't get a lot of opportunities anymore because the word is sort of out on him, but puts a lot of pressure on the opponent, particularly on those punts. Obviously now it's easier to control the kickoff, but the punt is still very difficult to control and keep it away from guys. Duvernay is really going to help the third phase for the Jaguars.
I do wonder, going back to Darnell Savage with Antonio Johnson, obviously young in his career, is he the nickel? Are the Jaguars now only looking for an outside corner? With obviously we expect maybe pick 17, pick 48, somewhere in there. Is Antonio Johnson your nickel corner?
I don't sense that he is necessarily the nickel 100% of the time. I think that's matchups. I think that comes down to who you're playing. He's a big nickel. And teams use more big nickel than they've used, and maybe they'll use some of that. So he'll be at the nickel some. I don't think there's any question. To Hayes' point a minute ago, you're going to see him some there. I'm not completely convinced he doesn't push those two guys. I think he's a really good player. I think he's going to push both of them. I really do believe that. I think Cisco and Savage will be the starters, to Hayes' point, but I think he's going to push both guys. But I think he'll be the nickel some too. The reason you get Darnell Savage instead of just handing the keys to both Antonio Johnson and Andre Cisco, you're in your window. As much as I sound like a broken record, that's why you make all these moves. All these moves. You go get a center. No matter how much fans don't want them to, they like Luke Fortner. But after the way he played last year, he's not ready to be to take you deep into the playoffs, and that's what they think they are. I cannot emphasize this enough. Maybe you don't agree. Maybe it doesn't happen that way. But they believe they're a team that's going to go deep into the playoffs. And when you're a team that thinks you can get deep into the playoffs, you go get everybody you possibly can get. And that's what they've done.
Well, they also got a backup quarterback. As of yesterday, we saw
that's
the
a big part of Mac that, too. Jones that's a big part of that, too. That if they do have – Trevor did get hurt four times last year. If he's down a few games, you want to play a guy that started 42 games, is a former first-round pick, is a guy that has been to a Pro Bowl, albeit as a reserve or an alternate, still been – over a guy that started 13 games. So Hayes, I think the storyline here is they created a lot of cap space by moving on from Darius Williams and moving on from Foley Fatakasi. They created a lot of caps, but Rayshon Jenkins, obviously, to build a team that they think is built to go as deep in the playoffs as they've gone. I'll say this again. No matter how many people were upset with who they are, they've had back-to-back winning seasons. For the first time in 20 years. They've only had a team for 30 years. Okay, so it's been a long time. Back-to-back winning seasons. They won the division and a playoff game a year ago. They were one quarterback sneak away from winning the division a second year. They feel like they're close. They've won 18 games plus a playoff game, 19 wins in the last 2 years, and the predominant amount of the guys on that team are back. They've lost very few players of significance that impacted those 19 wins. I'm not saying none, but very few players of significance then impacted that. They feel like they've got coaching quarterback. They feel like they've got a very good wide receiver room that got better today. They feel like they've got a very good running back room. They feel like they've got two really good edge rushers. There's a lot of good. They like their linebackers. So the storyline, Hayes, to me, is one that I expected all along. This is a team that thinks they're very close to having a deep playoff run. Go bring in as many players who can add to that as you can.
Yeah, and I would imagine that most of the heavy stuff is done, and that's fine. That, you know, they weren't working with the kind of cap space that some of the other divisional rivals have, but I think very productive. And again, we know they're gonna bring in at least two more really important cogs, the 17th pick and the 48th. Now they could move down and things like that, but we know for the most part they're bringing in two guys that should, if they're right, have a significant impact immediately. And if you get anything, you know, from the comp third and beyond, then great. But yeah, I mean, they don't have a ton of holes. They have a hole at corner, which is
obviously 17.
Which is what I would think.
Unless they go defensive tackle. That's the only other position that's
right.
I agree.
See
at 17.
Good point.
Yeah, and so, you know, I think as they go into the draft, other than corner, I mean, I think would you take a receiver? Yeah, you might if the right guy is there. But they're not going into the draft with four glaring needs. You know, you can – again, if you were thinking they were going to go center or interior offensive line, I would think the moves that they've done, they wouldn't need to do that now. So we'll see. You know, it's going to be – and they've also put themselves in a position that if a guy falls that maybe isn't the biggest need, but they feel like is a really special talent at 17, they've got a little bit more freedom now to take that player, and then you go corner at 48.
Can I still have Brock Bowers? Is that what you're saying?
Sure.
I'll also say I'm not completely convinced they're done either. I agree with you. The heavy lifting is done. I mean, they're giving a lot of money to some of these guys. But I wouldn't be surprised if you see a defensive tackle. I wouldn't be surprised if you see – I don't think a corner, because I think the corners of note are now too expensive or gone. But I wouldn't be surprised to see an interior defensive line.
If they got the extension done with Josh Allen, like we've seen two or three clubs do since they applied the tag last week, I mean, if they do that, then they've got significant room, because that number I would assume would go from $24 million probably to 7 or 8. So you could then take that money allocate it to a defensive tackle or, I mean, another one or two positions.
Yeah. What about Calvin Ridley? Everybody now assumes he's gone, but he isn't gone yet.
It is funny.
A lot of other players have signed. He hasn't.
Yeah, it is funny that we know a hefty percentage of the heavyweights in terms of their next destination, but no word on Ridley yet. So I don't know. I mean, the national reports, after they signed Gabe Davis, I thought that was the pivot away from Ridley.
I did too.
And there is some saying that the Jaguars still feel like they're in it with Ridley. I'd be interested in seeing how that would materialize. Obviously, I think they would cut Zay Jones to free up some space. But yeah, he's still out there.
Okay. Lauren's got some news.
Yeah, apparently Will Lutz has decided to stay with Denver instead of coming here. So he's going to sign a two-year deal with the Broncos. So the Jaguars still need a kicker.
Okay. Remember, all that can be reported now is news reports. There's no signings till Wednesday.
Right, yeah.
So they're only news reports. So maybe Will Lutz will
Adam
not
Schefter
come here.
Adam Schefter tweeted that out.
Yeah, so maybe Will Lutz is going to stay and not come here. It would appear that's the case. He's got a better chance to kick that 68-yarder there than he does now. It's here, that's for sure, with the atmosphere there. So we'll see. I'll say this again about Ridley. I haven't seen the national reports or all of them, Hayes, that you have. I will tell you once again that what we all know, and I can tell you I know, is that they really want to keep him. That I can tell you is that they really want to keep him. Now, whether it plays out that way or not, and I'm like you, Hayes, the minute I saw Gabe Davis, that told me they weren't going to be able to. But I'm not going to believe he's not here until I see that he's not here. Now, again, I'll say that in an hour. You'll see he's headed to the Chiefs or wherever. But I do know that I'm not surprised that there's national reports that they're still in play for him, because they were going to go to the mat for him. That I do know.
Yeah, and again, if they release Zay Jones, which you would have to, you wouldn't be able to have...
We can't have both.
Yeah, four veterans, Ridley, Kirk, Jones, and Davis. So, you know, if you release Zay Jones, you save like $4.5 million in doing that. You know, that certainly would give you at least a start on clearing the money that you would need to clear the addition of Ridley.
Yeah, I don't sense that they can't create the money to match Ridley's offer, whatever it gets. I question whether they want to spend it that way. At some point, how much money do you want to do? They're paying Christian Kirk a lot of money. They're paying Gabe Davis a lot of money.
Well, and again, it goes back to do the Josh Allen deal.
Right.
You know, I mean.
Which they're trying.
Push that over the edge. You know, get that deal done, and then you've got a lot of flexibility.
Yeah, and we all three know that they're trying. We all know they're trying to get the Josh Allen deal done, which could happen. It's not necessarily going to be right up until the July 15th deadline. So we'll see what that happens. As for other NFL news of note, Hayes, I guess Kirk Cousins is the big news. Christian Wilkins the big news. What are the other gigantic stories as you see it that are not Jaguars related?
I thought it was interesting that Saquon Barkley stayed in the NFC East, going from the Giants to the Eagles. I'll be interested in seeing how really all those running back deals work out for the teams that are going. Pollard to the Titans. I don't think Josh Jacobs has a home yet.
Yeah, he does. He's still the Packers, I think.
Okay, and then they released Aaron Jones.
That's correct.
Okay.
They've let him know they're going to release
him.
Yeah,
and so it'd be interesting to see what happens there. I tell you, the guard money has gotten really crazy. You know, Ezra Cleveland, I thought that was a good deal when they announced that a few days ago. You've seen a couple of guards get massive contracts today, well north of $20 million a year. So definitely makes the Ezra Cleveland deal look way more palatable in hindsight there. So that's kind of been an early storyline as well. But then the quiet nature of the Texans, Colts, and Titans, because I don't think, you know, the Titans signing Pollard is much of a game changer, particularly when you're losing Derrick Henry. But I really thought the Texans would make a couple big splashes. Haven't seen that really yet. And the Colts have been rather quiet. Yeah. And they've got a lot of cap space. So that was kind of interesting. And again, it highlights the greatness of having an owner like Shad Khan, because you never have to worry if you're a Jaguars fan, do I have an owner that's willing to spend? Do I have an owner that'll write the check? Shad Khan, 100% of the time, has written the check that his GM has asked him to write throughout his years as being owner here. And that's something you shouldn't take for granted. There's a lot of owners in pro sports that drive their fans crazy with how cheap they are. Shad Khan has gone above and beyond every single year that he's been the owner here to make sure that free agents are coming in on this day.
We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll say hello to Nick Morrow, the AD at UNF. They put on the Haight for the 17th time today. That's next. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
Joe Coward.
Are you like me?
Matt Hayes.
Let's keep this between us.
Mia O'Brien.
I'm adaptable.
And Leon Searcy.
Bring it in.
XL Primetime.
All for one and one for all.
Yeah! Noon to three weekdays on 1010XL.
Hey, sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. If you're still in the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is a one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with a real-life Vegas experience right from the comfort of your phone. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the MyBookie website. Sign up now and take advantage of a generous welcome bonus on your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200, get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun doesn't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide who to put your money on. The best part about MyBookie, you can bet on anything, anytime, from anywhere. Use promo code 1010XL to secure your welcome bonus today. Only with MyBookie. Again, that promo code, 1010XL.
Whether you're in need of a simple AC repair or it's time to upgrade your HVAC system, Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to help. Give us a call today to schedule an estimate, 904-862-6769, or online at duckduckac.com.
At Hodges Mazda, we are proud of our solid reputation in the Jacksonville community. Lauren Brooks here. As your hometown Mazda dealer, our high customer service standards and our huge inventory of new and used cars provide our customers a consistently first-rate car buying experience. Our professional non-commissioned sales team puts your best interest first without exception. And every vehicle purchase from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com and discover the Hodges Mazda difference.
Is your roof showing signs of wear and tear? Call Universal Roofing Contracting today to schedule your complimentary roof inspection. Right now, get $200 off your roof replacement plus flexible financing. And as a bonus, receive free window mitigation with a full roof replacement. This offer expires March 31st and restrictions apply. Universal Roofing Contracting, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Mia O'Brien.
Fun-loving girl.
Weekdays on XL Primetime.
Likes to laugh, lives to love. No dull moments tolerated.
Mia's quick hits are driven by Arlington Toyota on the video and social channels of 1010XL.
Hello, First Coast. I'm sure by now you have seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We're an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We're committed to customer service, reliability, and have an unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today from GFL, Green for Life.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit performancepaintingjacks.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Are you suffering from shoulder pain? If you have clicking and popping in the shoulder joint, persistent pain that intensifies with use, an inability to lift your arm over your head, or a tingling, burning sensation in the shoulder, elbow, or wrist, waiting to see a doctor could make your injury worse. Baptist Health and Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute have innovative and effective treatment options available right now to relieve your pain and restore your mobility. Don't wait. Call 904-JOI-2000.
For the greenest, luscious lawn on the block, choose the local legends, Roundtree Sod. Don't just settle for ordinary. Let Roundtree Sod deliver you a picture-perfect lawn. To get a free estimate, call 7414-SOD. 7414-SOD.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It's a Best Bet Monday on The Frangie Show with fantastic locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and now in St. Augustine. It's Best Bet.
We sure thank our friends for the Best Bet. Don't forget that Run Good event, number one, $400 no limit hold'em with a $100,000 guarantee. That starts on March 14th all the way through the 17th to the end of the week. Frank Frangie, Hayes Carline, Lauren Brooks, our buddy Nick Morrow joined us, the athletic director here at UNF. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. I appreciate y'all coming out. It's beautiful right now. Oh, the wind died down a little bit.
Yeah, a little cooler earlier. Yeah. But it is nice. We're at Sawgrass, by the way, the 17th annual Haight Invitational, which is really one of the best college golf tournaments around, man. You got to be proud of the fact that it stays so prominent, Nick.
Yeah. Yeah, and actually we're even starting to elevate it a little bit more. Like, you know, last year we were in February and we had a couple years of February runs, and then now we've moved it to March. And we're going 18 holes a day for 3 days as opposed to 36 one day, 18 the next. And then you're also doing it leading into TPC week. And so, and you're doing it at a golf course that's hosting Q School, mm-hmm. you know. And so mm-hmm. the combination of that is actually going to draw a better feel moving forward, too. And we had five top 25 teams compete this week here.
Five
top 25 teams here. So, and, you know, it's some of the best golfers in the country right now, highly ranked in the PGA Tour U rankings. These are future pros out here. And so the whole tournament took next level up. And a big reason that's the case is, you know, former UNF coach John Brooks came back to lead a committee together of former UNF golfers, people in the community, and said, okay, what do we do to elevate the Haight even more? And these are some of the moves that were made. And so last night we actually had a coach's dinner at the Brumos Museum, which, you know, if you've ever been there, it's amazing. It's a very cool experience for our coaches. And then tonight, you know, right after we're done here, going across the street to the Beach Club, and they're having a big post-tournament party with all the student athletes and coaches and donors. And then we're actually, those PGA Tour players that competed in the Haight at some point in their career were invited to come to the Beach Bash. So we'll have some that are in town for the TPC over there hanging out with some current student athletes. And just like that experience, the total experience is being elevated this year, and that's going to help us attract even stronger fields moving forward.
North Carolina, Alabama, those are two of the top 25 teams. Who are the other ones?
Virginia, Duke, and UNF.
Right, of course.
I know we didn't exactly play like it this week, but we're not going to go there.
Yeah. I mean, earlier this
but
year.
But it's important that you point out, though, UNF is a top 25 team in the country year in and year out. I mean, think about, we probably don't talk about that enough. I mean, not top 25 FCS or group of five or whatever, one of the top 25 programs in the country.
In the country.
Yeah. Period. I mean, that's pretty good.
No, it's, Schroeder's obviously done an incredible job recruiting talent, developing talent. We've got Nick, as soon as he's done with his eligibility, he's going to go right into a pro and onto a tour, most likely the Corn Ferry Tour, based on his PGA Tour U rankings right now. Robbie has a chance to get in there and get automatic status. Philip Knowles has PGA Tour status right now. A couple other guys grinding on tours. And so, we got pros out there. We got top 25 teams, a lot of championship. I don't even know how many years in a row we've been to NCAA. I think it's like 15 or 16 now.
Wow.
Which is, I don't know how many schools across the country that can say they've been to 15 or 16 regionals, and then another, five, six, seven finals in that time span too, which, again, not a lot of schools can say that period across the country.
How special will Nick be in terms of all the great athletes that this school has produced?
Well, he has accumulated more ASUN golfers of the week than any other ASUN golfer ever. Wow. And there's been a lot of talent that's rolled through here, not just from UNF, but the conference as a whole, and he's in the running to be, I think, four-time player of the year. Nobody's done that. His accolades can accumulate to what no golfer's done, basically many athletes, period, have ever done through here. And so, obviously, he's got a great chance. He's going to come out of college with great tour status opportunity. He's actually playing in the Valspar in a couple weeks. He's going to miss one of our tournaments and play in that, which is his home course, which is a really cool opportunity for him. And so, if he keeps the right attitude, the right work ethic, sky's the limit for him.
The accomplishments of this golf program, pretty amazing. Let's get to some other stuff. The ASUN tournament was fantastic. I hated it for you guys. Dominated the game, I thought. Dominated the game in Austin Peay. ASUN officials, God bless their souls. Chaz Lanier and Dorian James both foul out in the overtime. That had to be a gut. That was a gut punch.
Yeah, I still, as you're talking about it, the sick feeling came back real strong.
Because I feel you. And I'm not the AD there, but I hear it. I think for all of us that were watching it at the time, but it was a good year for those guys.
It was a great season, and just what could have been is what, besides just losing in that fashion, it's just what would have been next. We would have hosted a semifinal game.
I know it.
And even if we had to go to Stetson, that's right down the road.
Right.
And we just whooped Stetson last day of the regular season.
Right.
And we should have won the first time we matched up against them.
Outplayed them the whole game.
Outplayed them the whole game. And so just the opportunities that could have, and you put so much into the year, and I'm not putting an ounce of what those guys are putting in, what the coaches are putting into them. They report last week in June, and they went with them the whole time, for the past 9 months, nonstop, and to get to that point and to have that opportunity and then just come up short like that, it is a gut punch for sure. And we'll rebound and rebuild and be ready to go, because we got a really strong core coming back.
Yeah.
I mean, we had Jake, who's a grad transfer, who's done, and then Dorian, a six-year guy who was putting in a ton of minutes, more games anyways than anyone else in a UNF uniform. But we've got a really good core. Now we need to make sure Chaz comes back.
That was going to be our next question. The
world we're in right now, there's Power Five programs that are reaching out to him in the middle of the season.
Have to be.
There is.
Yeah.
I mean,
he told us.
Even though that's not allowed.
Even though it's not allowed.
Yeah.
It's happening. And so, but we'll have good conversations with Chaz. The thing is, he doesn't need to go to that level to be seen.
Right.
People know who he is. He's all over the top rankings from field goals, three-pointers made, to most efficient players in the country. Like, the NBA, there's been half a dozen NBA scouts that have come to games and practice. Like, they know who Chaz is, so he doesn't need to go to that level.
Is NIL in the fight? Do you have to look up and go, okay, Team X offered him X dollars? Does that happen?
That's probably going to happen at some point. He hasn't gotten like hard offers. Okay. He's not in the portal.
Right.
Technically can't get those offers.
I get it. Yeah.
We're gonna have, you know, conversation. I know Coach Driscoll's already started talking. We want to do what's in the best interest of Chaz. Does Chaz want to do? He's gonna have his UNF degree at the end of spring.
Okay.
And so, you know, we're really happy with that he's graduating from UNF with a degree. Now we want him to be able to use that COVID year with us. What does that look like? What can I do for you, Chaz, to do? Because again, you know, and I think he's a really smart kid, very humble, got good family, good support system around him. And be like, you know, you stay at UNF, you're playing 35 plus minutes every game.
Right.
You go to that Power Five, like, you know, love Jarius, love Jose, but they're playing minimal minutes with minimal points.
That's right.
Like, you need to keep playing. Like, that's how you get better. And so I think he understands that aspect of it. And then it's our job to make sure we give him as much resources as possible to succeed, from an exposure standpoint, to a schedule standpoint, to a financial standpoint. You know, and so we're working really hard to invest in our basketball programs right now. Where we are going to be by the end of this semester compared to where we are a year ago is going to be night and day in terms of resource standpoint. We'll be at full cost of attendance, full Alston Academic Award. We're going to announce a locker room project here real soon. We're going to renovate the north side of the arena. That includes new locker rooms for basketball, updated training room, and a new video room. We're going to start fundraising also for a new practice facility. Won't be ready for next season, but the locker room will. And then we'll have a collective started by summer too. So we're putting all the pieces into place to help us thrive at not just our level, but in general. We're putting all those pieces together. Now, you know, we'll need the community to come in and support that as well. Like, we can't do it ourselves, but we're putting all the pieces in place to take that next step as a program.
That's awesome. What do you like about the baseball team so far?
Great start. They're just won another series this weekend over Seton Hall. And so now that's fun coming up. Now is conference season. So conference play starts this weekend. Baseball goes to Queens. Softball hosts Austin Peay. Men's and women's tennis starts hosting conference play this week as well. And so this is really like the season within the season. Now it's conference play, and it's exciting to see where you're at. But all those programs are having some success right now and winning records, and can't wait to see what they can do with that.
You mentioned you had a party at Brumos. Can you take Chaz to Brumos and be like, hey, pick out something?
I think those individuals who own that fancy collection of old race cars might take exception to that. But
dang it.
You know, we'll make a phone call. Who knows?
Were you at the baseball game when the umpire lost the count?
I did not. I was not there.
That's fantastic.
I did hear about it. Joe kept me updated because filed a formal complaint and wanted to make sure I was aware of it in case I heard about it. But yeah, that's there's a few people that lost their mind on that one.
UNF was out of the inning, call a third strike, but the umpire thought it was only two strikes.
Ooh.
Team went on to score four runs.
Four more runs.
Four run inning.
You know, it's just officials right now. I mean, just after the whole basketball game and that, and then that kind of thing. And all they had to do was like, go to the scorebook, have a conversation with them, but he refused to do it.
He went
check all his sources.
Right. Well, the other umpires weren't paying attention, and the other umpire and Joe told him, Merck said, just check with the official score.
Yeah.
Check, and he
went,
no, I'm good.
That should be mandated.
Yeah.
I don't know why you wouldn't check all your sources.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And of course, the visiting team coach is kind of sitting in the dugout.
Of course, he was.
See how this plays out for us.
Tell you what, Nelfin. Nick Morrow is the AD here. This is a great event, man. You ought to be proud of this. I know you are. I know Scott's proud of it. It is really cool to see the looks on the faces of the players that come here. I know they're great players. They're playing a lot of events, but none better than this one at a better course. So this cool job out here.
Well, and it's amazing that John Haight's been involved in it for so long, and that his name's on this tournament, what he's done for UNF golf and for UNF athletics and UNF period.
Yeah.
Like, there's no one like him, and so live that and forever. He'll always have that legacy here, which is pretty amazing.
And we never do a show. We didn't see John today, but John will always come by, say hello. John's one of the good ones. He really was a good one.
So
really, Nick, thanks, buddy. We appreciate it.
All right, thanks for having me.
One segment to go. We'll be back to wrap it up with Lauren's news and notes after this.
The Frangie Show, live from the Hastings Injury Law Firm Studios on 1010XL. Hit back with Hastings.
This is Brent Musburger's Action Update, brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, here are the latest lines from my guys in the desert.
The UConn Huskies are the betting favorite to win the national championship and to repeat as national champions. It'll be the first repeat champion since Florida in 2007. UConn plus 480 to cut down the nets in Phoenix. The Houston Cougars, the top seed in the Big 12 tournament this week, are plus 650. Purdue is the top seed in the Big 10 tournament. They are plus 750 to win the national championship. Arizona and Tennessee, both plus 1400 to win the national title. The Wildcats, the top seed at the Pac-12 tournament. And the Volunteers, the top seed at the SEC tournament in Nashville. And North Carolina plus 2,000 to win the national title. This update brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, a proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. I'm Tony Desiri with your VSiN Action Update on 1010XL.
Attention all business owners. The raining season is coming, and it's important to ensure that your property storm drains are free from debris and functioning properly. That's where Duck Duck Rooter comes in. Our powerful VACCON truck can effectively clean out your storm drains and prevent costly damage to your property from flooding. Don't let clogged storm drains ruin your business and reputation. Call Duck Duck Rooter today to schedule a cleaning before the rains hit. 904-862-6769 or online at duckduckrooter.com.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loans. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Did you hear what's happening? Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet are spring cleaning. New inventory on the ground means we need to make more room. Take advantage of huge savings on thousands of vehicles priced to sell. New and pre-owned prices have been reduced, and all sales associates have been instructed to give maximum value on all trades. But you better hurry. The best deals go first. Head to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville to take advantage of our spring cleaning sale. We're here to wow you.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella windows and doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
Get ready for the Players' Championship, March 12th through 17th at TPC Sawgrass. Don't miss your chance to watch the PGA Tour's best compete to etch their name in history while enjoying a vibrant social scene. From local bites to the latest merchandise available in the PGA Tour fan shop, the Players offers the ultimate experience for everyone to enjoy. Secure your spot today. Tickets are on sale now at theplayers.com.
Hey gang, Hicken here. March is Workplace Eye Wellness Awareness Month. Here's a tip for those in front of a computer all day. Follow the 20-20-20 rule. Set a timer as a reminder to look 20 feet away every 20 minutes for 20 seconds. This can be as simple as looking away from your computer screen or out the window. If virtual meetings keep you in your seat for extended time, shut your eyes for 20 seconds. Call or visit BowdenEye.com today to schedule your consultation. BowdenEye, keeping the First Coast focused.
AgPro has been family-owned and operated for over 64 years. Need a new tractor, parts for your used equipment, or reliable service? AgPro has you covered. Visit us today at any of our AgPro locations or go online to agproco.com to get started with your AgPro experience.
A big win for the Florida Gators.
Get inside the Gators with the Florida Gator Report.
I'm Taylor Dahl, and I'm your Gator Updater. Listen for the Gator Report several times a week on 1010XL.
Brought to you by Darley's Plumbing, where quality counts.
Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you. For lost or broken keys or nearly any make and model of vehicle, call 722-1111 for Instant Keys Locksmith Service.
What defines a hero? Dedication, loyalty, courage. Every day at AAMCO, we serve heroes. For over 60 years, we've repaired and maintained the most critical public service vehicles. From complex transmissions to simple brake jobs with flexible financing and the extra safety precautions we need. The heroes we serve don't all wear uniforms. They're people like you. At AAMCO, we're proud to serve all of you. AAMCO.
Money tight? We can finance almost anybody. Find the AAMCO transmissions nearest you at AAMCOJacksonville.com.
Firefighters, paramedics, police officers. They take care of us, and at AAMCO, we're proud to take care of them. For over 60 years, we have repaired and maintained the most critical public service vehicles. As an essential business, we work on every kind of car repair with flexible financing and extra safety precautions. Essential, reliable, trusted. That's the men and women who are there for us, and it's our honor to be there for them. AAMCO.
Family owned and operated in Jacksonville, Orange Park, St. Augustine, and St. Mary's, Georgia. AAMCO Transmissions and Total Car Care.
Exciting news from Leonard Truck Accessories in Jacksonville on Blanding Boulevard. Stocking brands like Real Truck, UWS, WeatherGuard, Carry-On Trailers, and more. The best deals with the best prices only at Leonard Truck Accessories on Blanding Boulevard. Leonard, your truck, your style.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
What's going on in the world? It's time for Frangie Show News and Notes. Here's Lauren Brooks.
All right, gentlemen, a couple Jaguars news-related items we did not get to. We did not discuss that the Jaguars could not come to terms with linebacker slash special teams ace Caleb Johnson, who will become a free agent. And we did not get to the fact that Blake Hance, the offensive lineman, signed a contract extension. So all the other moves, just wanted to mention those as well.
Blake's a good, versatile guy. He'll be the eighth or ninth lineman. He's a good locker room guy. He's a very well-respected guy. He started with the Browns for a while there when Baker Mayfield was there. Baker had the legendary line. We got a brand new line. We had some guy named Blake. But Blake Hance's a good football player. You know what? And he's a good guy. When he's your eighth or ninth offensive lineman, you have a pretty good line. Good for him. Caleb Johnson, very good special teams player, and he'll be a good. But you can only pay so many guys, and that's kind of how it goes.
That is how it goes. Also, Foley Fatakasi, we didn't get to this, will sign a one-year deal with the Texans. Any concern there, Hayes?
Well, he's trying to get out of the deal now that he knows that Luke Fortner isn't going to be starting at center for two of the games he's going to be playing. It's a fine. Him going to the Texans, that doesn't bother me. I'm stunned at how little action Houston has had so far. Now, obviously, it's early and things pick up, but you are seeing some big players find new homes. Fatakasi going to the Texans, that's not going to keep me up at night.
Yeah, Foley didn't play well here. You know, don't wish any ill will on Foley at all, but he didn't play very well here.
Bengals wide receiver T. Higgins requested a trade after having the franchise tag placed on him. Any chance he could come here?
I wouldn't think so now. I don't know if they're ever going to pay that kind of money with Gabe Davis coming. I wouldn't think so. But I got to believe somehow they work it out, because that changes the Bengals exponentially if they don't have him. I mean, they got Ja'Marr Chase, but I'm saying he's a good player now.
He is a good player, and I agree. That's their identity, is that high-flying passing game. So I wouldn't expect Cincinnati to honor the request. If they do, you know, then, again, if you're the Jaguars and you're interested, you've got a couple pieces. Again, if you could do the Josh Allen extension, that would free up some cap space. Cam Robinson has a high number. They haven't really done anything with him yet. Could he be released? That'd be $16.5 million in savings. I think he should be. Then, obviously, you'd have money to go make a T. Higgins deal happen. I'm surprised that as of now it's going to be, I guess, Walker Little is a swing tackle. He's going to end up being a free agent and leaving, and you know, we'll see, and he'll have barely played, and you know, to invest a second round pick in him is surprising to me. So if the Jaguars wanted to do something with Cam Robinson, that would open up a possibility for a T. Higgins deal. But where they are right now with Cam Robinson and the Josh Allen deal not being done and having to factor in $24 million on a franchise tag, I don't know how they could make it happen.
I think by now Cam Robinson's on the team. I think if there were, in fairness to him, If he wasn't going to be on the team, we'd know that by now.
I would think.
Cam Robinson's not going to be on. There's not much doubt about that.
Another guy that I would love to have here in Jacksonville, Derrick Henry, according to Jeremy Fowler, is unlikely to return to the Titans. Can we bring Derrick Henry home?
You know what's funny about that one?
I would love it.
You know what's funny about that one? I don't hear any whispers that they are.
Yeah.
And I still think Derrick's got something left to start for somebody, and that wouldn't be the case here. But it ran through my mind. I mean, they brought back in the last 2 days two guys who are from here. One from Nassau County. Gabe Davis is from Fernandina Beach. Mac Jones is from Jacksonville. They're both on the team now. Derrick doesn't have a lot of years left. The Jags have not been a good short yardage team. They have not been good at third in a yard, third and two, fourth in a yard. I don't think it's happening because I think he's going to go somewhere with a chance to play. But stranger things have happened. I think that would be fantastic. I would love Derrick Henry to be on this football team.
Oh, it'd be fantastic. I'm with Lauren. I think it's a dream and it's a great one. But I gotta think Dallas or Baltimore or
he's gonna go start somewhere.
That's what I would think. But yeah, if that falls through
wouldn't
for
that
whatever
be,
reason,
wouldn't that be fun though?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I'd love to have him.
I would too.
Most girls dream about Taylor Swift tickets. I dream about Derrick Henry, the Yulee bulldozer, coming back to Jacksonville.
And I will tell you this. The plan is to get better in those short yardage situations.
Correct.
And to have a downhill runner, which is what they want Tank Bigsby to be. And by the way, I think Tank Bigsby is going to help them there. I think he'll be better than he was. But if you can have Derrick Henry for a year, and this is your year now. I'll say this again. They believe this is their year. That'd be pretty cool.
I would love it. Chris Jones, I think that's another guy that certainly Jaguars fans would have loved to have here. But he has signed a 5-year, $95 million deal with the Chiefs, and 95 of that million guaranteed.
Yeah, it's smart. You know, Kansas City holds on to their core as best they can. The one team that I'm intrigued by is the Eagles because I don't really like where it's going for them. Kelce retires, Fletcher Cox retires. Then you go and pay Saquon Barkley. I'm interested in seeing what continues to happen with Philadelphia and do they slide at all? Because we talked about it, losing Kelce is so big and Fletcher Cox.
Yes.
I mean, they've really lost the heart and soul of their roster. And, you know, again, Saquon Barkley is exciting, but he's had durability issues and things like that. So loved what the Chiefs did, haven't loved what the Eagles have done so far.
Were you a little surprised, though, that it's a 5-year deal for Chris Jones when he is 29?
I think it's just that, I mean, he shows no signs of slowing down, and I think it was just, let's just get it done.
That's right.
And, you know, if we have to, you know, eat some dead money down the road, we'll do it. But he's just, I mean, he's just become really, I mean, each year's better than the last one with him. And, it's just, unfortunately, you know, he's staying in the AFC.
49ers star defensive lineman who Trent Baalke drafted in the first round, Arik Armstead, will become a free agent. Again, I don't think he lands here, but another good player on the
market. He's a good player, man. He is a good defensive lineman. I think there's a move or two left for the Jags, Lauren. I don't think it's an expensive player, though. I would love to see it. We all would. But, no, he's a good player. They did not want to lose him, but they just couldn't get together on dollars. So I like him as a player a lot.
Did you see the ESPN, the switching gears a little bit, did you see the top 100 baseball player rankings?
I didn't.
So they came. Did you see him by
no.
chance? So they released him today, and one thing that stood out to me, the Braves, by the way, had 8 total. That was tied for first with Houston. The Dodgers had 7. So the Braves had 6 in the top 36, but the one ranking that I was surprised by, Trout is now 19th.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's he's not first, second, or fifth anymore.
And he's 19, been hurt, right?
19 seems low.
Yeah.
Now, he's older, but that – And they got pitchers. They got everybody lumped in there together.
Closers,
starters, I would imagine. I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
But that'd be low. I'd have to look at the list, but that would seem low. Where's Mookie Betts?
He was 4th.
Okay.
And you know he's switching positions.
Yeah, he's going to play shortstop.
Yes,
yeah, we'll see
Gavin
if that.
Gavin Lux, so far, has been disappointing in string.
And Gavin Lux is not a good shortstop. He wasn't ever supposed to be a shortstop. Gavin Lux was a left-handed hitter that could play second or third and short in a pinch. He was never supposed to be a shortstop. We'll see if that one holds. The pressure on a shortstop to play is enormous. I mean, that's why good offensive shortstops are so hard to come by. So we'll see if that one holds. I think Mookie Betts is one of the best players in baseball. I'm surprised he's 4th.
Yeah, it was Acuña, Judge, Soto.
Okay.
And then Betts.
Acuna.
They had Ohtani like ninth.
Yeah, that's low.
Which was
that's
surprising.
Good. Acuna
two of
won.
The top ones are on the Yankees, in other words.
What's that?
Two of the top four are on the Yankees.
Yeah, two of the top three.
Acuna won, I can live with. Judge is second.
Judge was second, Soto three.
Yeah.
And then
that's high
four.
For Soto for me. That's really high for Juan Soto for me. So.
One college football note, Boston College is hiring former NFL head coach Doug Marrone as the program's new senior analyst for football strategy and research.
Yeah, that was sounds like that was Bill O'Brien giving him a job. I thought he may wind up as the offensive line coach. He's not that. He's just going to be analyst guy.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Maybe he wanted more of the analyst role versus the on-field role. In college baseball, we talked to Nick Moore a little bit about UNF baseball. Florida did walk off St. Mary's Friday night, Frank, 12-11 in 10 innings. Saturday lost 9-7. Yesterday won 10-0 in 8 innings. I think people, as of Saturday, were starting to really freak out about Florida's pitching staff.
Well, they're still going to because it's not very good. The reality is this. They need to move Brandon Neely out of the bullpen. He needs to start on Friday nights. They need to make Ryan Slater their closer, who's a really good pitcher and doesn't get enough. They got to consider, do they want to keep leaving Caglione on Sunday or do they move him to Friday or Saturday? Look, they're 10-5 now, I think. They play somewhere there, but I think they're 10-5. There's two undefeated teams left in the country.
Florida State.
And Texas A&M, and Florida plays them in the next five games.
Yeah, Texas A&M is ranked fifth. Florida, that's how Florida opens conference play this weekend.
By the way, go ahead.
I was just going to say, Caglione's numbers from yesterday, Florida does have one star pitcher, as we know. Six inning pitched, zero hits, zero runs, nine strikeouts on 98 pitches.
Yeah, he's pretty amazing. Florida State and A&M are the two undefeated teams left. Florida State's 14-0. A&M's ranked fourth, and they're 13-0. In Division I baseball, which is the Bible, that is the ranking service, Florida State's unranked. They're not in the top 20.
They are ranked in the other one.
In D1, they're not ranked.
They're 21st in NCAA, I guess.
In D1, they're not ranked. They're 14-0. I mean, how are they not ranked? Now,
Florida is 10-5.
Yeah, so Florida's 10-5. FSU in Gainesville on tomorrow night, and then they play the A&M series that may be on the road. I don't know if it's – but they – yeah, so interesting.
It's home against A&M.
Yeah, they got to figure out their pitch. They can score, but they don't pitch.
Like you said, Florida State undefeated, beat New Orleans 13-0, 15-7, and 8-0. And then this weekend, FSU plays host Notre Dame. Talk about a really good offense that Leek Jarrett has.
Yeah, they're really good. UCF's really good. I told you, Rich Wallace, the coach there, they're really good.
Yeah, absolutely. UNF took 2 of 3 from Seton Hall, like we mentioned. And then UNF is at Florida A&M tomorrow. First pitch at 4 p.m. Opens conference play this weekend at Queens. JU lost all three at Cal State Fullerton Friday 12-2, Saturday 13-2 in 7 innings, and Sunday 15-3 in 7 innings. JU is at Bethune-Cookman tomorrow. First pitch 6 p.m. And then JU opens conference play this weekend against Stetson.
Yeah, that's an important series. Stetson's pretty good, and JU's really struggling right now. Important series for the Dolphins and UNF as well as they both start conference play.
Yep, absolutely. Other news, let's get back to the Jaguars before we finish the show. Everyone's favorite move on our show, Mitch Morse, the center, replaces, or at least we think provides, or probably starts, but provides certainly competition for Luke Fortner.
Yeah, I think we can say competition all we want. He's the center. And now, again, in a year where they think they're going to go try and win, their offensive line is veteran Cam Robinson, veteran Ezra Cleveland, veteran Mitch Morse, veteran Brandon Sheriff. That's three guys in their 30s. Cleveland's not in his 30s, but he's close to it. And one really good second-year player in Anton Harrison. It's a veteran line that they believe got a chance to be very good. And now Walker Little and Luke Fortner are the sixth and seventh guys.
Yeah, Morse was an A++++ move. That was a fantastic addition. And looking forward to seeing what kind of impact he can make. Did you watch Scheffler yesterday?
I did not.
If he plays the way he played at Arnold's event here, he will become the first defending players champion. He switched his putter. Yeah. He can't miss. He didn't miss a putt under 15 feet yesterday.
There's never, as you know now, there's never been a repeat champion of the players in 50 years.
Right.
And there's only two guys have ever won Bay Hill and the players in the same year. Tom Kite, my guy, and – and who's the other one? There's two. There was Tom Kite.
It's got to be Tiger.
Did Tiger do it? Probably
yeah.
Tiger.
Well, yeah, he
probably.
Won Arnold's event every year he played
then
in
he probably was Tiger,
and he
yeah.
won the Players twice, yeah, so I'm going to assume that.
I'll bet it was. How about yeah. me? Knowing Tiger and Tom Kite and some other guy. That's what I just said. It's Tom Kite right. and another guy, yeah. not, and I wasn't making that up. I just saw it.
Final question. Florida plays against the winner of Georgia-Missouri on Thursday night, 9:30. Who would you rather Florida face, Georgia or Missouri?
Missouri.
Missouri. Yeah, they haven't won a game. They haven't won a game in the league. Yeah. yeah so, but I think Florida will beat either one of them. And I'm not as confident as Hayes is that they'll beat Alabama in the next game. But they match up well with them. Should have beat them twice. You know, had them beat and then went to overtime and then rolled them in the last game. So we'll see.
All right, let's say hello to Blue.
Now, the two-minute drill. Brought to you by Tire Outlet. Tire Outlet is now hiring. Visit TireOutlet.com/careers. Equal opportunity employer.
Rick Blue joins us. Rick, quite a haul for the Jags, it looks like. What do you make of the group?
I'm pretty impressed with everything that has gone down, particularly, you know, addressing their biggest problem, and that was center. So to go out and get Mitch Morris and be able to take advantage of getting a head start on it because he was released last week by Buffalo. So good move there by Trent Baalke. I thought he got him for a very affordable number as well. That's really the biggest surprise about this, the two-year deal for Mitch Morris. Not in love with the guard play. I've been kind of against that the entire year. You know, a couple of guys getting up there in age, although Cleveland's only been in the league for, I think, 5 years. But certainly Sheriff, and now you look at Morris and you look at Cam Robinson, you're looking at three guys who've been in the league now for 8 years or longer. So certainly some veteran leadership there. But overall, I thought it was a good day. The biggest surprise to me was Darnell Savage. I didn't see them going after a safety, and that's the surprise for me. But you know, I went back and did a lot of reading on him. He's a pretty quality football player, so looks like that was a good signing.
Yeah, I was with you, Rick. I thought Antonio Johnson would immediately become the starting safety, but now they've got some numbers there, which is a good thing. All right, what's coming up tonight on the program?
Well, we're going to talk with a defensive back. He's 30 minutes away. We'll get in, get things rolling with Aaron Beasley to talk about the Jaguars secondary and just the Jaguars overall. And, you know, we'll hopefully no one else will flip. I mean, we used to only see that in college football signing day, but with the situation that went down a little bit earlier with place kicker Will Lutz. We'll keep people updated. There's still some huge names out there who have yet to sign, including Calvin Ridley. So we're going to be busy here over the next couple of hours.
Rick Ballew goes into the night right now. Thank you, Rick.
See ya.
All right, that'll do it for our program. We're live here at Sawgrass. Thanks, our friends at The Best Bet, always a Monday sponsor. Tomorrow, we'll be at a different kind of Sawgrass, the Players' Championship, the rest of the week, as will the rest of our daily programming. So we'll see you from the Players from the stadium course tomorrow. Don't go anywhere. Rick Beluga's into the night right now. For Hayes, Lauren, and RJ, I'm Frank Frangie. So long.